now.
And go to the window.
Open it.
Stick your head out and yell.
Made it by! Top of the world!
The voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
You know I don't speak Spanish. In English, please.
Look in my eyes. What do you see? The cult of personality. The cult of personality.
And now welcome to a Monday edition of The Voice of Ocala. I am Buddy Martin with you again. Another week. Glad to be here in the studios of the palatial studios, I should say, of WOCA in the Paddock Mall. We are with you each weekday from 3 to 6. Tom Schmidt, my broadcast partner, does the Tribunator on Tuesdays, gives away the store, and action-packed week of guests and things and topics and tons of things to talk about today in the news and sports and another great football weekend, and we'll try to sort it all out the next 3 hours and make a little sense out of it. Hope your weekend was good. I was on assignment, and literally I was on assignment on a project, which I will reveal a little bit about today, only because there are other people involved. I can't talk about it, but I just say that it involved having to be somewhere to visit with somebody on a project I'm working on for right now, and that happened to be the beach. And so there you go. I was at the beach, but and watching, of course, all the football on Saturday as I did, and another terrific weekend. Sad day for the Gators. A very, very sad day for the Gator fans. I know they're all angry and mad or sad, but I can tell you, even the coldest-hearted Gator would have to look at that game. And despite the fact that you might like to throw Will Muschamp out right now and get rid of him, many of you would, you have to say, can a guy ever catch a break? And my response to that on the weekend on social media was, the only thing about Will Muschamp in terms of a break is his broken heart. He really had some unfortunate luck, if that's the right word. Maybe you don't believe in luck. But the coincidences were just, it was about as tough a loss as a coach could possibly take, in the way he took it. And we'll go break that down today for you. Everything from the clock to the play to the drop to whatever, the things that happened. There's so much drama in the last 6 minutes of that football game. And a neutral fan could really enjoy it because it was right up for grabs if you didn't even have a rooting interest. I know, Tom Smith, you caught it because you were texting me back and forth, and we had lots to talk about. And I don't know how you felt about it, but, boy, I tell you, a lot of folks questioned the call, which I'll get into a little later, about not just stopping the clock. That's the one thing. Stopping the clock, putting time back on it, and giving LSU a chance to kick the winning field goal. Now, having said that, I know people say, yeah, well, you're going to start complaining about the officials. No, I'm not really. I'm just making an observation, and I'll explain it further on during the program when I get a chance to tell you what one of the replay officials told me about the rule or the situation. But, Tom, it was a bizarre game, wasn't it?
It was a bizarre football game, and I texted you. I actually texted you and said, this one can't be placed on Jeff Driscoll's shoulders, although people will because of that interception that led to the game-winning field goal. People will say it was Driscoll's fault. But drop passes, missed opportunities, and a drop pass in the end zone that reminded me sort of like a pro football game, a Dallas Cowboy dropping a touchdown pass in the early 80s that catapulted the San Francisco 49ers to victory.
Yeah, so as I said, we'll get into all that particular aspect of it and what happened.
Well, I think we should talk the whole 3 hours.
Yeah, right, in the sports hour, because we need to preserve a little time for other things. But we're going to have, we've confirmed, we've got Jen Finneran, formerly a Notre Dame writer for South Bend, Indiana. He lives in South Bend now. We're efforting to get a hold of Ira Schofield from War Chant. Hopefully he will be joining us. I put in a call to an SEC replay official, but he says he can't be on today. So we're working on that. On the show today, we've got a couple of fellows who are very involved in our community, people we've gotten to know who are sort of business partners of ours, as one of the sponsors of Marion County High School football, which Tom James and Tom Schmidt so eloquently do. I don't know if eloquently is like
– I'm not really sure eloquently would be the word I would use.
All right. And that's the Sizer brothers. Navroz and Azim will be here today at 4 o'clock. They'll introduce you to people that, if you don't know them, they're delightful folks to be around. They have a commitment to business in this area. They own a string of hotels, three of which are in Marion County. And we'll visit with them and tell you what they're about. Big, big, big Gator fans. I think they were at the game on Saturday. So we'll have a few thoughts from them on that as well. SEC weekend, we talked about a time earlier. What's coming up? Pretty good games. We'll discuss those, break them down for you a little later on. This week on the show, we're going to have our friend Dan McCall will join us on Wednesday to talk about Kimberly's Cottage, something that's very near and dear to people who are concerned about child abuse and victims of sexual abuse, children. Naturally, the mayor will be on at 3:30. Teddy Goss joins us on Thursday as we kind of kick around an idea for a show called Throwback Thursday, which could be kind of interesting. So those are some of the things we have planned on the show. And, of course, the Tribunator will be here giving the story away on Tuesday.
Yeah, I don't know about giving the story away, but I'm surprised you missed the biggest story of the day, buddy.
I missed anything.
I'm surprised you missed it, that the oldest son of Willie Robertson of Duck Dynasty has gotten engaged. How'd you miss that story?
How about that? Yeah, I'm sorry. I don't know how I missed that. Should have been on my radar screen.
I can't believe you didn't get like an alert on your phone or something that, you know.
Yeah, I'm sure you did, though. You did probably got one.
I did, by the way.
No doubt you got one on yours.
No, really. On a serious note, they've identified the Dallas nurse that has Ebola.
Yeah.
And this is, okay, I'm starting to maybe think Buddy Barton might be onto something here.
Well, let's talk about it after break. And the question is, what is this disease? How is it transmittable? Is it a threat to us? And why do we keep learning things every week about Ebola that we thought we didn't know? And all of a sudden now it's taking on a little different shape of things in terms of what we should be aware of. And we don't want to do one of those, you know, kind of shows that make people nervous or do wring your hands. But it is a fact that Ebola is here. And now every day we read, every week we read something else we didn't know. Suddenly this disease has been transmitted to a nurse here in the United States. So all we can do is bring up the stories, talk about them. Maybe at some point get an expert on in health and medicine we can talk to about it. But it's of concern without question.
I'm not real sure there's a whole lot out there right now, buddy, that are experts.
Yeah, not much known about it. So let's go ahead and take a break, come back and join you on another side, talk about that story on Ebola and other news, including a new county administrator on the horizon right here on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Located next door to Silver Spring State Park and a few minutes from historic downtown Ocala, our award-winning Holiday Inn Express Hotel and Suites of Silver Springs is the place to stay for a friendly, memorable, and fun experience. Enjoy our fast and free Wi-Fi, complimentary hot breakfast, and free parking. Whether you're in town for work or play, our friendly staff will make you feel right at home. That's the Holiday Inn Express and Suites of Silver Springs. Proud sponsor of Friday night Marion County High School football on WOCA, The Source.
If you've been hearing about the crowded Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill and were worried because you couldn't get in, I've got some good news for you. Seating is now available. While you're there, look up Chef Dave Del Rio. He'll buy you a drink. Now is the time for you to finally see firsthand what your friends are talking about at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Check out those gorgeous Lakeware sunsets. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill on beautiful Lakeware. Seating now available.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Who would you feed if you had 50 chicken sandwiches from Chick-fil-A? WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall have teamed up to reward one organization with 50 chicken sandwiches as a way of saying thanks for the great work that organization is doing in our community. And we need your help. See, there are so many great people doing great things that we need nominations. You can nominate your own organization or any organization you choose. Simply send an email to WOCA@WOCA.com. And in 350 words or less, tell us why the organization you are nominating should receive 50 free chicken sandwiches from WOCA and Chick-fil-A at the Paddock Mall. We'll review your nominations and then select one deserving organization each month. We'll announce the winner and even read the winning entry on the air. Make sure to include the contact name and phone number of the organization that you are nominating. And thanks from your friends at WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall.
What you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Talking about ourselves stimulates the brain the same way love, food, and cash do. Everybody's favorite subject is themselves. So, on a date, ask her about herself. Adults studying a new language learn words and phrases faster when they sing them. Normal, happy cows produce about 9 gallons of milk a day. But super relaxed and happy cows produce more than 10 gallons.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Welcome back to The Voice of Ocala. I'm Tom Schmitz for this news update. It's been a while since the Marion County Commission has been here, according to this story by Bill Thompson in the Ocala.com. On Tuesday, the Alachua County Commission is expected to ratify a contract with Lee Niblock, which will trigger his resignation as Marion's administrator and formally launch a local hunt for a new staff chief. Based on comments made last week, commissioners hope to fill that post in short order. It's prudent for Marion County to move in a direction quickly and swiftly and move to the next opportunity it has for its constituents, Carlos Alex said at Tuesday's meeting when Niblock's departure was confirmed. On Tuesday, it was suggested by Human Resource Director Amanda Tart that the board could advertise the opening on websites its own, as well as employment venues such as Monster.com. She also said the county could hire consultants and told the board that her informal survey of nearby counties that had been looking for new manager revealed most of them had gone that route. Commissioner Earl Arnett immediately told his colleagues he would oppose that, citing the expense. Such a move would cost the county up to $25,000. Going forward, however, commissioners face a series of challenges and questions that did not exist 12 years ago, Howard said. So these things need to be looked into. Buddy, that's the news update here from about the county commission, but here's what gets me. This is a line that scares me. On Tuesday, it was suggested they could advertise the openings on websites. It's on as well as employment venues such as Monster. It was also suggested that they hire a consultant And because that's how almost every county in the state does it. And the commissioners, Earl Arnett in particular, said, nope, I'm not spending that money. So you're telling me that one of the top 10 largest counties, money business-wise, fiscally-wise, money-wise, in the state, is going to find the administrator to run the county by using monster.com?
That sounds a little bit odd that they would do that. I just texted Lee Nimblock and asked if he could come on before he leaves. I don't know if he will or not. We've had him on this show probably a half a dozen times. I've had lots of conversations with Lee, private and otherwise. I don't have any real insight to this except just my gut feeling is that I remember a story. It seems like it was about 3 years ago in the Star Banner where the county commission graded Lee Nimblock. And he didn't get great grades. So there were a lot of some mediocre grades in there from the commission. Now, it's a different county commission, and one of them that actually was on the county commission no longer there. Actually, two of them. So I remember that story, and I wondered how he took that. Lee Nimblock brings a certain expertise in certain areas that I think are much needed. He, of course, was very successful in the Penny for the Parks program in terms of getting 1 cent sales taxes before he got here. Very much, very, very adroit at that. I'm not sure how the county or how the commissioners feel about losing Lee Nimblock. I can tell you this. I think we got to get with the 21st century, however, and realize that going on monster.com and getting resumes is not the way to go when you're looking for someone to come in and make as much money as they make and to be the head of the top figure in the county office and having a bunch of applicants throwing their names. First of all, I don't know how qualified they are to do that in terms of reading resumes. Secondly, there's always that little possibility of conflict of interest, although I would hope any commissioner would recuse himself if they knew the party. So
we're talking about a job that's $163,500 a year.
Big
job. Although Lee Nimblock started, that's what he made in 2009 and hasn't ever gotten a raise. He stayed at $163,000. For all intents and purposes, buddy, besides the five county commissioners, that position, county administrator, is the face of Marion County. He's the face that goes to Tallahassee and negotiates and stuff.
Yeah, and although he can't vote,
right,
the county commission technically works for him.
He works for the county commission.
Technically, he works for the county commission. Bottom line is that he is able to exercise his judgment in many areas,
right,
without approval of the county commission. And so I think it's,
what are we going to do? Put an ad on Craigslist? Hey,
yeah.
If you've ever if you ran a lemonade stand before, come on, Marion County's going to hire you as a county administrator.
That sounds a little backwards, doesn't it? It does sound a little backwards.
I just don't understand when you're talking about that kind of job in charge of as many employees as the county administrator is in charge of. Well, we're just going to use monster.com. We don't want to spend $25,000. We're just going to use monster.com. Sometimes there's expenses you have to do. And I would think spending $25,000 to hire a company to help you do a thorough vetting and thorough search and vetting of candidates is $25,000 well spent.
I agree.
Am I wrong there?
No, I agree with you. I agree with you. And, you know, by the way, let it be said that he beat out three other people in Alachua County who wanted the job. And they obviously, I don't know what they, we got to find out what that pays. I'm sure it's much more. I say much more. I'm going to guess that's $200,000 or your job in Lochway. I don't know.
I would guess. Now, Barbara Fitos, you know Barbara well.
Yeah, I have a high regard for Barbara. Yeah,
Barbara, who was a county commissioner in 2006, 2010, that's according to the story on Ocala.com. She was a vice president of human resources at Regions Bank. She suggests the commission convene another workshop to thoroughly go over the process and qualifications it seeks and Nimblock's successor. And then she said they should invite somebody, if you don't want to spend money, invite some retired corporate human resource executives who live in the community to participate in the discussion as advisors, as well as seeking help from the Florida Association of Counties.
All good suggestions.
She said, here's the problem finding his successor. The depth of Dr. Niblock's understanding of county government and community will be difficult to match. That's why a successor will also need personal skills as well as strong experience running a major agency. Aside from they will need to have someone who goes beyond the technical experience but has the ability to manage and interact with the community as a whole. She noted that while people familiar with Florida would have a distinct advantage, the commission should also see if there are any available and interested parties from across the entire nation.
No. Although he is a public figure and he is somewhat the face, I don't think the average person knows who Lee Niblock is, actually, because he's not, you know, the subject. He's not in the news in terms of what happens at the meeting because he doesn't vote, and I doubt very seriously if many people know him. Very important part of the cog, however, in that machinery, and someone that is your leader there, basically. It holds together the thing because under the sunshine law, commissioners can't obviously talk to each other except in workshops, which is a way of getting around it. So I would say that this is a very important hire for our future. Those of you out there who complained about you were upset about the way the county commission is going and some of the things they're doing, although the county administrator, again, won't vote, a sharp county administrator can save you a lot of grief. Someone that could help engineer through some of these waters, and an important one for the next 25 or at least 15 or so years, because the person you hire is probably going to be in their 50s or early late 40s, whatever, I would imagine. So very important person that we're going to hire here. Looking back on it, I'm trying to figure out what it was that took place, why he applied. I think he applied for other jobs, too. I believe that's right. So I'm putting all this together and saying, okay, the report card that he got a couple years ago, not real favorable. I believe it was like a B- or a C+ from that, telling him he was not doing a good job. The fact he hasn't gotten a raise since 2009, and by the way, most people didn't. I mean, there was a downturn in the economy. But again, sending a signal that, you know, that what is his value to the county? And in general, the group of people who are on the county commission right now, I can't prove this. I don't think that was his favorite. This is me surmising, not putting words in anybody's mouth. Those are all factors that added up to make him look to move someplace else. Obviously, he liked the location because he didn't move, but 35 miles up the road, he probably would probably keep his house here and drive back and forth. So don't know about that. But again, we need good leadership at the top. It's extremely important to get the right person for this county administrator job. I hope, Tom, you're right. I hope they go beyond. Take Barbara Fitos's suggestions and find somebody that can again, lead us and lead the county commissioners to the promised land. Is that too much to ask? I don't know. back to the story about Ebola.
The starting salary, by the way, real quick, on the county manager.
$200.
It can range depending on experience, it can range anywhere from $145,000 to $198,000.
Okay, that's the same ballpark.
Well, I promise you he's not taking $163,500 just to move counties. So it's going to be, I would think it'd be north of
$163,500. Yeah.
Running, this is what's amazing to me, buddy. Alachua County, $325,400,000 a year general fund budget.
What's ours, do you know?
I do not know ours. Yeah. I could look that up. But he's going to a county that's smaller. There's only 274,000 people that live in Alachua County.
But there are a lot of students. And a lot of universities right. Got 50,000, 60,000 right. People there.
Right. You know, so it's a wash, really.
Yeah. But in terms of the actual community and the population and the censuses, yeah, we're a bigger county.
And they needed these people. You were supposed to apply before August 18th. So this was something that happened recently.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, we'll stay on that. It's a topic that we'll kick around on.
Oh, and
show.
He's retired to live within the county boundaries. So he's going to have to move to Alachua County.
Okay, well, yep. There you go. That answers that. That answers that. All right, I want to get to this Ebola story, although I know it's not one that we have a lot to exercise. We don't have a lot of information other than what you hear. But I think it's important to bring it up and mention it at least to have some dialogue on it. So I'll just say that you know by now with the weekend they found a second person in Dallas with Ebola, and it's a nurse. And what I want to say about the story is that yet again, we learned something that we didn't know before. were led to believe that probably wasn't going to happen. That anything would have had to be, you know, to be somebody who was infected in Africa,
right,
and come over here. But now we're seeing the cases who were, that were apparently contracted here in our country.
Right. And I watched the, after the break, I'll tell you, if we have time, I'll tell you, I watched the CDC news brief about that at around 12:30 today.
Yeah, well, you can do the break stuff. Also, I'll tell you what they're doing in London. They're being proactive about it. I'll tell you some measure they're taking. And I heard Glenn Beck talking about some of the things that he thinks that the government ought to do in terms of, you know, requiring the airports to be shut down and or screened more thoroughly, which we've said on this show now for several weeks. Why are they letting people fly out of Africa without, you know, being more stringent? They're getting through the system, obviously. And I guess last time I heard, we had five screening
five major airports
set up here in our country to do that.
Right.
So, but we'll see. Talk about that also. What about vitamin D? Well, I learned something new about vitamin D. I'll tell you about that, too. Coming up next right here on The Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Being the Culligan Man is not easy, because he works hard every day for you here in North Central Florida. Whether you need bottled water delivery for your office, a home water softener, or water infiltration system, the Culligan Man can help you. At Culligan North Florida, we have dozens of softener and filtration options, along with a host of media tank sizes. Depending on the exact hardness and usage of your water, we determine the size of softener you're going to need. And if you're on city or well water in one of our local areas, the in-home water analysis is absolutely free. If your needs are for the home, call Ocala Water Conditioning, 352-291-5900. For home or business bottled water in Ocala, call Ocala Bottled Water, 352-291-5900. Culligan of North Florida, a proud sponsor of Florida State Football, heard right here on WOCA, The Source.
My name is Bo Briggs. I'm a sixth-generation Ocala, and I practice law with my father at the Briggs Law Firm. Over the years, we've seen many changes to Ocala and many changes in our profession. What has not changed is our commitment to our clients. You will speak with and get to know your attorney. That will never change. A lawyer will personally handle your case, not a paralegal. So if you've been injured in an accident and would appreciate personal attention, you can reach us at 671-4600 or learn more at thebriggslawfirm.com.
Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75, exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt, golf, and a car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala, proud sponsor of Friday Night High School Football on WOCA, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Pat O'Neill. Think Ebola. That's what federal health officials are telling hospitals, urging them to get up to speed after a Dallas nurse got the virus while treating an Ebola patient. Those who came in contact with the nurse, meanwhile, are being monitored.
If this one individual was infected and we don't know how within the isolation unit, then it is possible that other individuals could have been infected as well.
Dr. Thomas Frieden of the CDC, a warning of dangerous storms in a big chunk of the nation.
Tornado warnings around Bastrop. This is Louisiana and towards Arkansas and towards Tennessee. We're dealing with a tornado warning. It looks like rotation with this storm.
Fox meteorologist Janice Dean, at least one person died in Arkansas overnight due to storm-related activity. A suicide bomb attack in Baghdad has claimed 12 lives, as many Shiite families were celebrating a major holiday in Iraq. Fox News, we report, you decide.
You've packed your family of eight in a five-person car, packed a week's worth of groceries into one bag, and when your wife says the dishwasher's full, you just laugh. But are you up for the challenge when there's 20% off on the line? Pick up our exclusive 5-gallon Napa Camo Bucket for just $2.99, then get 20% off all the stuff you can fit in it. Conquer the job with Napa Know-How. at participating Napa Auto Parts stores while supplies last. Some exclusions apply. Offer expires 11/16/14.
Let's get down to business. You don't travel too often for work, but when you do, you want to stay where you know you'll be taken care of. That's where Choice Hotels comes in. We have everything you need to keep you on top of your game, like free hot breakfast for that much-needed morning boost, free internet to keep you in touch with home base, and a generous loyalty program so you can earn great rewards. Stay for business at Choice Hotels and book now at choicehotels.com. Great endings begin here. Amenities vary by location.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Neil Shusterman, an award-winning New York Times bestselling author. He's written a book called Undivided, a young adult novel, the last installment of the Unwind Histology.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin will be in the studio answering your questions about your lawns and your gardens on her show, In the Garden with Carol Ann.
Emily Bell Freeman is an inspirational speaker and author. She's written The Peter Potential, Discover the Life You Were Meant to Live.
Joe Reichel will be in the studio from Damage Control Services. He'll be answering your do-it-yourself home repair questions or maybe give you advice on which professional would be best for your circumstances.
Randy Henderson is a 2014 Grand Prize winner of the Writers of the Future Award. He'll be on the air speaking about his book, Fin Fancy Necromancy. It's a murder mystery novel.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Friends, Saju brothers, Azim and Navras, on their way in, call from Dunn Allen. They're going to be joining us at 4 o'clock hour, sort of introduce you to the folks in the county who are talking about economic drivers and businesses and what have you. And these young men have really done a terrific job of, in the hotel tourist business. I know that one or maybe both of them serve on the tourist board very actively. They operate a Holiday Inn Express out at Silver Springs, a Sleep Inn here on the Bellevue exit, and Howard Johnson's on the 27 exit off I-75. And they're very involved in the community and getting more so. And they're one of the sponsors for the Marion County High School football, but they're also, their kids play soccer and just all around really interesting people and good citizens. And they'll be joining us here as we visit. We talked to Navras years ago on Angie Lewis's show about, almost 4 years ago now, we were down at Harry's, had a chance to visit with them. You'll like them. They're good people. On this thing with Ebola, Tom, by the way, Dr. Buddy is in the house. He'll be along shortly. This mystery disease, as I said, something keeps popping up almost every week that we didn't know. Now, I'm not sure it's because it's so new, although we've had certainly lots and lots of things like this in our country. I mean, the Spanish flu epidemic they had back in 1918-17 wiped out millions of people around the world and a lot of people here. Ebola, of course, hasn't really done any damage in that regard, except a couple of deaths. But it's such a scary disease because it seems like we know so little about it. So the news that we got over the weekend was a second person developed Ebola in Texas. And she is during time she might have been contagious, which is the scary part. It's a nurse at Texas Health Presbyterian. She cared for the first person diagnosed with Ebola, Thomas Eric Duncan. And it's really still unclear about how she contracted this virus wearing protective gear. And that's the part about it that concerns me. I mean, if they're wearing this protective gear, how is it happening? She's being treated now and is in stable condition, according to officials at the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. The health officials identified this one person who had the contact virus and monitoring persons who signed other signs of the disease. But they also clearly, I don't think, A, they were really prepared for it, my opinion, if you keep reading things and hearing things about stuff slipping through the cracks. And B, I don't know, hopefully the protocols are set up, but like I say, every week it's another story about something happening in Ebola that surprises us. So for that reason, it concerns you and it concerns me. Now, let me give you an example of a story of a country where they have doing something proactive. I read this today. In London, ambulances and medics in protective suits are sent out to anybody calling the health emergency hotline with Ebola-like systems. They're dialing a phone line, 111, used for non-life-threatening emergencies. Asked if they've been to West Africa recently, if they show typical signs of having contracted the virus. So far, no cases of Ebola have been reported in Britain, but they expect to have some coming in a few months. Now, this is the thing. Although this disease is centered in West Africa, in Guinea, Liberia, and Sierra Leone, it has already claimed 4,000 lives. And I like what London's doing. They're not sitting around waiting. They're saying, hey, you think you got it? Call this number. We'll come get you. Stop it right then. And we remember the story of the last person who had it. Remember the story about what happened to the nurse, to the guy, Thomas Eric Duncan, who apparently slept in an apartment and slept in a place. And then they didn't even change the sheets. They didn't even do anything to sanitize the apartment. So the
7 days.
The next day, they still hadn't done it.
They hadn't done it for 7 days. Yeah, it sat away 7 days.
So if they had a game plan, a protocol, what happened there? And so that's what concerns me. It's not like, oh, okay, well, it's all in Texas. No, it's all in Texas, but it also affects all of us. I mean, there are flights, last time I checked, to Dallas in Florida, I do believe. So I just don't feel like the CDC has been on top of this. I don't know how you feel out there. But to me, it's disconcerting. And I haven't seen a ton of stuff out of the White House that made me feel any better about it. So I understand why talk show hosts like Glenn Beck get on and rail on about it and bring up the fear factor because, you know, all talk show hosts like to scare people. While I'm not panicked about it, I'm concerned. And you should be too.
Well, Thomas Frieden, the director of the CDC, the chairman of the CDC, had a press conference today where he says that this is not something to worry about, that you shouldn't worry about, that anybody can get this thing, that this nurse, obviously, and they're doing an investigation, and they say their investigation is showing that she broke protocol when taking the garments and the clothing and all off. And that's how they believe she,
you know what worries me?
Contracted this.
You know what worries me? The fact he's telling us not to worry about it. That's right. What worries me.
Well, here's my thing. If she broke protocol, why wasn't somebody in there watching her saying, hey, you just broke protocol?
Yeah, exactly. So not a good system of checks and balances.
And now they're talking about they want to not want to euthanize her dog.
Yeah, I know.
And now it's unclear whether dogs carry the Ebola virus or they don't carry the Ebola virus.
Yeah, exactly.
We're about to have a pandemic on our hands and a panic on our hands if they don't start saying something.
It sure seems that way. Sure seems that way. You know, over the weekend, do you still take a lot of vitamins and stuff, or do you take
I actually had a bad outbreak of the gout this weekend where literally Saturday and Sunday I couldn't move because my foot was so swollen. And I had stopped taking my vitamins. Jennifer started pumping me full of vitamins again this weekend, and within 48 hours, I'm able to walk and put stand and everything. And she went online, and she found what vitamins, and sure enough, all the vitamins I'm taking help with gout, and I just quit taking them over the last 2 or 3 weeks.
I stopped taking them about 4 or 5 months ago. And the reason is I didn't see, you know, I read a bunch of stuff about really you just wasting, you know, they're like sugar pills, you know. And I read an article about the fact that it was all part of, you know, of the scheme or the scam to sell people vitamins they didn't need. We know we've been thinking for a long time that vitamin E was good for you, that it's not good for you. So I had a discussion over the weekend, talked with my friends about whether they took vitamins and whether it mattered or not. And these are two women who friends of my wife's, and one of them said, "Hey, you should be taking vitamin D." And I said, "Why?" "Because, you know, I used to take vitamin C. I took so many of those.
Well, vitamin D is the sun.
I know. I was in it some this weekend. So then I read this article from Harvard Business School or Medical School. Now they're saying that low in vitamin D can be tied to aggressive prostate cancer, according to this article written by Charles Smith.
Okay, we have to do the show from outside now.
Well, we almost are with the sun coming in here. The story says, as a nutrient, vitamin D is surely essential. Without it, we couldn't absorb the calcium and phosphorus we need for healthy bones. But research increasingly points to other benefits of vitamin D. One of these is possible protection against cancer. Scientists are finding out that vitamin D can slow the growth of abnormal cells, but also starve tumors by making it difficult for them to sprout new blood vessels. New findings suggest that prostate tumors in particular can become highly aggressive when a man's vitamin D levels are low. A report in the journal Clinical Cancer Research showed that the lower the vitamin D level, the more aggressive the prostate cancer. So it goes on to talk about how it grows. It adds to a growing body of evidence that vitamin D may be important in several areas, cancer being one of them. Goes on to cite the doctors, and it quotes the Harvard Annual Report. Hart says, of a doctor, Dr. Mark Garnick, and associated with Gorman Brothers, professor of medicine at Harvard affiliated schools, says, in my practice, vitamin D and, if necessary, supplemental calcium in appropriate doses is generally a sound recommendation to consider. So this doctor is recommending this.
So we need all the vitamin D we can get to help with prostate cancer. So now I have a legitimate reason to tell Jennifer I must play golf every Saturday and Sunday.
About it. Exactly. Now here, there's also, you can get it in food, you know. I mean, you have to take
something. You can get it from walking in golf courses too, though. Oh, yes, riding around golf courses. Sun's out.
Certain types of fatty fish, eggs, some types of mushroom, foods fortified with the vitamin and then milk and other dairy products.
Well, I eat a lot of eggs, a lot of mushrooms, a lot of milk.
And then sunlight courses are going too. So you don't have to take the supplement necessarily. All right, we got time for Dr. Buddy now. We want to do it after break.
Let's take a break and then come back.
We'll give you that. Yeah. Plus, we'll give you our tweets and quotes and the Sajur Brothers up next right here, too. Stay tuned to the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Requires bank approval. Vehicle purchase price fixed rate allowance.
Fumble.
I was so busy making my fantasy football picks that I forgot to stock up on inventory, and now I need cars fast, so I'm calling for an inventory blitz. Chris Spears here from Prestige Auto Sales. This month, bring me in your old car, and you could score the nicer, newer ride you've been fantasizing about for just $10 down.
Sack your old car.
And start driving the nicer, newer car of your dreams for just $10 down. Don't get fouled by past credit problems.
Our For the People credit approval process is the game changer you've been waiting for.
We huddle up the banks and lenders to help you get approved and back in the game. So stop driving a car you hate.
Punt it and drive a nicer, newer car for just $10 down today.
I'm throwing in a Hail Mary to make my month, and I need your help. Trade in your old car and you could drive for just $10 down. But don't wait till the clock runs out. This deal is over when my inventory is full. I'm Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit us at Prestige Auto Sales or call 694-1234. Yes, 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
Hi, this is Randy Briggs of the Briggs Law Firm. Traditional help for truly injured. We trademark registered this belief years ago as our description of our practice at the Briggs Law Firm. By traditional help, we mean that clients actually meet with a partner in the firm who will personally handle their case, not a paralegal. Well, what about truly injured? We limit our practice to injury claims having merit with clients who indeed have been injured. So if you or a loved one have been truly injured, compare our credentials at the Briggs Law Firm.com or call us at 671-4600.
This is Allstate agent Kevin McDonald, and our agency is a proud sponsor of the Marion County Friday night high school football game of the week. I grew up in Ocala, and I'm proud to support high school athletics throughout Marion County. For all your insurance and employee benefit needs, contact the McDonald agency at 622-2333. Our agency has been a proud member of the Ocala Marion County community since 1985, with offices in Ocala and the Villages.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Big game this week. A lot of folks, Notre Dame and Florida State in Tallahassee. It's a top five game. What is Notre Dame found up, by the way?
Notre Dame is, I think, fifth or sixth, and Florida State second.
Look at the poll there again. So, like we predicted.
I'll look at it real quick.
It might be seventh. I don't know. Anyway,
It's a top ten matchup, though.
As we talked about last week, you know, Mississippi State will overtake Florida State, or the winner of that game. And boy, I was surprised at the first quarter of that game.
Notre Dame is fifth in the AP. And fifth in the coaches' poll.
There you go. Well, we said top five game, and there it is.
There it is.
Now it's a 2-5 and not a 1-5.
Well, you kept saying top five, and I tried to tell you, wait, let's wait a week, buddy.
You did.
You were right.
You did. You did. You tried to talk me off of it.
So. I did.
So, all right, let's pick a couple of things. Let's get a little music on. We'll talk about Dr. Buddy has having abbreviated sessions. It's very, very, very long.
I don't know about that.
By the way, just so you know, just full disclosure, about my weekend, I'm working on a book. I can't say any more than that about it, and I had to meet with the subject there. So we'll talk more about it. Books take, by the way, a lot of time. Tom, you were shocked when I told you about that.
I was.
I'll tell you about it at the beginning of the next hour, right before the Sagiros get here. Dr. Buddy, let's pick out a couple here. Which one of these do you want?
What's the subject? What's the topic?
Building a loving relationship, all right?
Steps to building a loving relationship.
Yeah, all right. Here's, I want to give you, we only got time for one. Number one, create a safe environment where you can trust and share openly without being afraid. Or number two, separate the facts from the feelings. And number three, connect with different parts of yourself. I'll give one more. Or develop and cultivate passion. Which one of those do you want, Tom?
Let's go with the third one.
You want connect with the different parts of yourself.
Yeah.
All right, here it is. This is what, this comes from an article written by your tango experts in Psych Central. So I just want you to know, Dr. Buddy has occasionally has to do some research. This comes from them. Each of us is not a solo instrument. We're more like a choir or an orchestra with several voices.
So we're like Sybil?
What is your mind saying, Tom? What is your heart saying? What is your body saying? What is your gut saying? For example, my mind is definitely saying, leave her or leave him. But my heart says, I really love her or love him. Let these different voices or parts of you coexist and speak to one another, and this way you will find an answer. And yours are correct. It's like Sybil. What do you say about that?
That's your head and your heart tugging at each other. That happens all the time, I would think, in relationships. The smart thing is sometimes to go and the heart says stay, or the heart says go, the head says stay. I think that goes on in every relationship.
You know what Dr. Buddy says?
What's Dr. Buddy say?
Dr. Buddy says you will know if it's the right person. You will be able to tell you. It's that other part, that sixth sense that tells you, I cannot live my life without this person, at least not now. And that will tell you if, in fact, you need to have this person in your life. It's all about that. You'll know the time when it comes, like your grandmother told you, one day, young lady, will knock you off your feet. You'll know that's the one.
You will.
All right, real quick, let's get our tweets and quotes music on. I'll give you my tweets and quotes for the day as we get ready for the Saju Brothers on a beautiful Monday. What a beautiful day. What a beautiful weekend it was. Number one, blessed man. Blessed is the man. Blessed is the man who, having nothing to say, abstains from giving wordy evidence of the fact. George Eliot. Mm-hmm. In other words, don't say it if you didn't got it. Number two, once you eliminate the impossible, whatever remains, no matter how improbable, it must be the truth, Sherlock Holmes. Number three, I've had a wonderful time, but this wasn't it, Groucho Marx. Groucho Marx.
That other one where you said a man, doesn't say anything.
Blessed is the man who, having nothing to say, abstains from giving wordy evidence of that fact.
That's kind of like, it's better to be thought a fool than to open your mouth exactly. And remove all doubt. All
right. If you ain't got nothing to say, shut up. All right, hour two coming up on the program right here, the Voice of Ocala. Stay tuned to
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Hi, this is Randy Briggs of the Briggs Law Firm. My son, Bo, and I practice exclusively in the representation of accident victims. And we've been asked many times why we would support and sponsor the program Ask the Cops with Sheriff Blair and Chief Graham, who are in the world of criminal law enforcement. Well, these legal rights actually overlap. In civil law enforcement, we're in the business of recovering for victims of accidents that which has been taken away from them and holding the responsible party accountable. Both civil law and criminal law share those common goals. So we're all in the field of law enforcement, and for that reason, we're proud to sponsor Ask the Cops on The Voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin. So if your family or a friend needs help in an accident situation, feel free to contact us at our website, www.thebriggslawfirm. We're located in the Ocala Historic District.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name. If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, "It's our business to make your business better." Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Each morning, we wake up thankful to live in a free nation with liberty and justice for all. But sometimes those liberties can be put in jeopardy, and you may have questions about what to do or who to call. Let Doc Blanchard of Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland help you find the answers. Attorneys at law since 1974 and located in downtown Ocala. If you have legal issues, don't go it alone. Call 352-732-7218. Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland, helping protect your liberties every day.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month that's working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com. Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offered as an unclear dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Do you have areas that have started sagging or drooping? Is what you're looking at not quite the same as it was years ago? Are there enhancements you've been putting off? Is there serious damage you need fixed? Then call on us, Damage Control Services. When your roof is sagging and the drywall is drooping after a storm, or your home just needs some enhancements, from damage repairs to new construction, Damage Control Services is here to help.
Got a garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
We are The Source, WOCA. Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. Educating healthcare workers is a must in the U.S. fight against Ebola, says the CDC.
We will double down on training, outreach, education, and assistance throughout the healthcare system.
Director Dr. Thomas Frieden, a Texas nurse who'd been treating the now deceased victim Thomas Duncan, is being treated for the virus in the same hospital. U.S.-led airstrikes against ISIS forces around the town of Kobani may be working.
CENTCOM confirming seven more today, as Turkey is now denying an earlier Washington claim that it has given the U.S. permission to conduct those strikes from its bases.
Fox's Greg Palcott. Tornado warnings are up for much of Arkansas and the Southern Plains.
Forecasters
Center say weather could get worse today, telling folks in Little Rock, Memphis, and Nashville to pay attention, with tornado watches and warnings extending in the overnight hours from the Gulf Coast to the Ohio Valley.
Fox Radio's Jeff Manasso. Fox News, we report, you decide.
You've packed your family of eight in a five-person car. Packed a week's worth of groceries into one bag. And when your wife says the dishwasher's full, you just laugh. But are you up for the challenge when there's 20% off on the line? Pick up our exclusive 5-gallon Napa Camo Bucket for just $2.99. Then get 20% off all the stuff you can fit in it. Conquer the job with Napa Know-How. At participating Napa Auto Parts stores while supplies last. Some exclusions apply. Offer expires 11/16/14.
Let's get down to business. You don't travel too often for work, but when you do, you want to stay where you know you'll be taken care of. That's where Choice Hotels comes in. We have everything you need to keep you on top of your game, like free hot breakfast for that much-needed morning boost, free internet to keep you in touch with home base, and a generous loyalty program so you can earn great rewards. Stay for business at Choice Hotels and book now at choicehotels.com. Great endings begin here. Amenities vary by location.
Yes, it's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind, because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry. We didn't leave you.
He's gone. He's not gone. That's the whole point. He's never gone.
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei.
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on. Stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Back to Voice of Ocala on a Monday. Beautiful weather over the last three or four days. Well, I could take this all the time. Coming up at 4:15, our friends, the Sajur Brothers, will be here from HDG Hotels.
HDG Hotels. They're the HDG Hotels Player to Game sponsor.
I kind of hate, I like to break them down because there's nine of them, and three of them are in Marion County. And I mentioned before when you were out, then, of course, they have the Holiday Inn Express in Silver Springs, one of the newest one of the bunch. Howard Johnson's on 27, and at the Bellevue exit on I-75, the Sleep Inn.
So, right. Highway 27 and 75 is the Hojo. The Sleep Inn is at Bellevue and I-75 exit. And then the Holiday Inn Express is right across from Silver Springs.
I think one of our friends from Brunswick will be staying in Silver Springs this weekend, as a matter of fact.
So, we got friends from Brunswick coming in, do we?
I think so. Well, maybe.
Wonder if is our friend from Brunswick a golfer?
Good question. I don't know how he'd ever work out.
Because my friend from Brunswick's a golfer. You know, I could take him out on the links.
Yeah, I don't know. That's a good question. But I know he's planning to go and be in Gainesville on Saturday.
Well, buddy, real quick before we get started with today, I just came across this and I find it so hilarious. You know what today is? Today's Columbus Day.
Yes, it is.
You know, a day set aside for the mythical founder of the New World. I could go into a diatribe on why that's inaccurate.
A little bit of an editorial comment, but go ahead.
I could tell you why that's not accurate historically, but regardless, Christopher Columbus was the one that the history books give most credit to finding the New World. And today's his holiday. Except at the Bank of Ann Arbor. All banks are closed all around the country except at the Bank of Ann Arbor.
Ann Arbor is in Michigan.
Where
the
Wolverines live. Yeah, the Michigan Wolverines live in Ann Arbor.
Such as they are these days, the maize and blue reside.
The Bank of Ann Arbor sent out this tweet at 8:30 a.m. this morning. Remember, folks, we will be open for business as usual. It may be Columbus Day, but we're not honoring it because Columbus is in Ohio.
Well, you know that goes back a ways.
Yeah, I know.
Late Woody Hayes. This is a true story. I've been told to me by more than one. They go on recruiting trips, and they go up to Michigan to recruit, and they be low on gas. And Woody would say, we're not stopping to pay taxes in the state of Michigan. We're going to drive it. You know, if we have
it runs out of gas, we'll push
it across the line. We're not buying any gas up here. So that's how it goes up there. On a sad note, a friend of mine, I got this note over the weekend, George Meffert. People who live around Ocala have known the Meffert family. There's a lot of them came from here. George was a couple of years younger than me in high school. And sadly, he and his family took a cruise from on the Queen Mary 2 from New York to Southampton. And 2 days into this trip, George began feeling not well. And he went to a clinic where he was diagnosed with pneumonia. And he stayed there for the remainder of the cruise. And when he landed, he was admitted to the hospital. They diagnosed as worsening pneumonia with a secondary infection. His condition deteriorated, and unfortunately, George died. The person who wrote this, of course, was a member of the family. He said George died with all of us next to him. And though it was still is horribly sad, he passed away very peacefully with us by his side. So RIP to the Meffert family and for the death of George Meffert, who, like she said, it was although sad, at least he passed with his family around him. So, all right, in this hour, as we said, we'll talk about the – I wonder if the Sager brothers would take you on a Faker Factoid, do you think?
Well, they may. They're probably pretty good at it.
Probably pretty good at it, right. We'll definitely have that match going on. In terms of lots of sports to talk about today, we got a new number one. I'm going to go over the – I've gotten several notes from our friends saying, when are you writing your column on the Gators? You know, and I said, well, I'm going to do it here soon. But I may have a little different take. You never know. Sports, we got a big game to talk about. Notre Dame, Florida State. We'll be talking to the editor, managing editor of warchant.com, Ira Schofield, about the Seminoles. Boy, they've had a busy week. Read a whole story on the New York Times over the weekend about what was wrong with the Tallahassee cops. And then we talked about some on the Saturday sports page. And, of course, Jimbo Fisher went off of the media today a little bit. You know what? I kind of have to agree with him in one respect. Even though there's a lot of, in his story of the New York Times of what looks like negligence or and the Tallahassee cops not being willing to pursue minor infractions by FSU football players.
It's just boys being boys, buddy.
Yeah, right.
What did you use the word countless number of BB gun incidents?
No, there's no question there's a lot more than I thought. I thought if it's one BB gun, it's a big deal. But if there's like 15 of them and none of them get reported, after a while, they're having BB war, gun wars. But nonetheless, I agree with this, that really there's not anything in that report that's new as far as Winston's concerned.
No.
So if it was something new that had been covered up, I'd be a lot more alarmed. Does it look like bad form? Yeah. Yeah, it does look like bad form. Does it look like – does FSU wish they had addressed it publicly early? Probably. You know, do you say – and we'll save this for Ira – but do you say good for him for, you know, for saying he's not guilty of anything and having a clear mind and playing like a player with a clear mind? I don't know. Do you give him credit for that? Jimbo says he should today. You should give him credit for that. So
– you know what you shouldn't give him credit for? His draft status, which is plummeting – like the national debt is rising.
Yeah, well, let's put it. Johnny Football was not a choir boy, okay?
And his draft status plummeted.
But he still was a first rounder. So
Johnny Football wasn't near the controversy Jameis Winston is.
All that talk is fine, and I get it, and I think conduct is important, and I'm not saying it's okay.
He won't drop out of the first round?
I don't think so. You know why? Because he can win football
games. Because he can win football games. Exactly.
If he can win football games, general managers are willing to look past an awful lot.
Trust me, if Ray Rice is reinstated by the league, somebody's going to re-sign Ray Rice. Because he can help win football games.
They will definitely sign him up. So we'll talk about the Auburn-Mississippi State game. Oh, that was a crazy thing. The how about them Cowboys? Unbelievable. And I'll break down the Florida game for you. I've got it down. The play, the call, the pain. All of it, plus John Finneran from South Bend, and we also have our show for all coming up. And stay tuned.
Hey, I got real quick for sports. I got a reprieve for Dan Snyder that you may not have heard about.
All right, coming up next right here, along with the Sager brothers in the house. We're talking to them next right here in the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source. Eye Care Center of Ocala is centered on patient satisfaction. Our friendly doctors and staff are here to serve all of your family's eye care needs under one roof. Our optometric physicians take great pride in offering every patient the absolute best in vision care utilizing state-of-the-art technology. We're located about 2 miles west of I-75 on State Road 200. You can schedule an appointment for the Eye Care Center by going to www.eyecarecenterofocala.com or you can call us at 352-512-0560. The Marion County Seminole Club, Inc., a proud sponsor of FSU football here on The Source. For more information, contact the Marion County Seminole Club at marionseminoles.org or email them at marionseminoleclub@gmail.com.
Hi, I'm Buddy Martin, the host of The Voice of Ocala, every weekday from 3 to 6 right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. A lot of people ask me, how do you keep a muzzle on Tom Schmitz? Forget about it. Stay with us and sleep better at the Sleep Inn and Suites of Ocala Bellevue, located next door to Don Garlitz Museum and a few minutes from Florida Horse Park. Our award-winning, newly refreshed Sleep Inn and Suites offers comfy, clean rooms, free fast Wi-Fi, and service with a smile. Start your day with a deluxe hot breakfast and unwind in our heated outdoor pool. Our convenient 24-hour fitness and business centers allow you to stay on track whether you're here to play or to work. That's Sleep Inn and Suites Ocala Bellevue, proud sponsor of Marion County High School Football.
The next drink is on Dave Del Rio at Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill. Just ask him for it. But don't wait. Show up soon because this offer isn't going to last very long. Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill will be filling up fast because their friends from the north are headed back that way soon. The good news is that seating is now available and Dave's buying the first drink. If you've been hearing about the crowd at Eaton's Beach Sand Bar and Grill and couldn't get in, now you can see firsthand what your friends have been talking about. Great food. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Great location. Check out those gorgeous sunsets over Lake Weir. Great people. Starting with Chef Dave Del Rio, who began his career in 1978. This spicy guy has been instrumental in opening over 100 restaurants. And he's buying you a drink. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill, where there's little or no waiting these days. Come see what started out as Jay Eaton's dream almost 90 years ago. It's more awesome than ever.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Neil Shusterman, an award-winning New York Times bestselling author. He's written a book called Undivided, a young adult novel, the last installment of the Unwind Histology.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin will be in the studio answering your questions about your lawns and your gardens on her show, In the Garden with Carol Ann.
Emily Bell Freeman is an inspirational speaker and author. She's written The Peter Potential, Discover the Life You Were Meant to Live.
Joe Reichel will be in the studio from Damage Control Services. He'll be answering your do-it-yourself home repair questions or maybe give you advice on which professional would be best for your circumstances.
Randy Henderson is a 2014 Grand Prize winner of the Writers of the Future Award. He'll be on the air speaking about his book, Fin Fancy Necromancy. It's a murder mystery novel.
All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric.
Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala. My pleasure now to bring, actually, I think this is the second time Navras has been on the program with us. I think Azim's first, but I have to check on our history. Navras Saju is the president of HDG Hotels. Azim is the vice president and general counsel for HDG Hotels. Just to give a little bio, they're both big Gators, first of all. And right now, they're kind of hurting, and as a lot of Gator fans are, after a miserable, miserable finish to that game, which you might want to stay tuned to 5 o'clock. I'm going to break it down misery by misery coming up at 5 o'clock hour. It was tough to watch. But they're here with us today on the program, and we want to reintroduce Navras and introduce Azim to our audience. They're heavily involved in the community. I know that they had one's sons play soccer. I know that. Maybe both. I don't know, perhaps. But we'll find out. I know that they bleed orange and blue. And, gentlemen, welcome to the show. In your case, Navras, welcome back to the show. I'm sorry you couldn't have a happier occasion to be here.
Yeah. Well, thanks for having us, buddy. And yeah, we're still stinging from Saturday night. Yeah.
I know you took a crew up there, right? You took some people up. How many did you wind up taking up to the game?
We ended up taking around 7 people up to the game. And
we got to get you closer to that mic.
We ended up taking around 7 people up to the game. I actually was hoping against hope at the very end that they'd run back the return with, 3 seconds left. So I had everyone stay to watch the return. But
why not?
Yeah, at that point.
Why not? And there's so many parts of that we could sit here and talk about, but we do have a sports hour to talk about. But suffice to say that if you looked at Will Muschamp's face after that 3rd and 25, and the completion, and then the way the game ended with the interception and the field goal by a guy who couldn't make an extra point earlier in the game, 49-yard winning field goal, you have to say to him, he's thinking, what else could possibly go wrong in my life? Because everything has gone wrong for him and the Gators in that regard. So despite that, they're still not eliminated yet mathematically from the SEC East. I noticed today he made a statement. He still wants to get to Atlanta. And there were a lot of sarcastic remarks about that. Like, sure, I'll give you a ticket to a Greyhound bus to Atlanta. but anyway, so you know how Gator football fans are.
Yeah. The reason we follow sports is because we learn so many life lessons from sports. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it's incredible what the next game or the next week is going to bring.
Good point.
And the sports definitely rewards the resilient.
Very good. Hey, you may have to have your own talk show here to keep that up. Mm-hmm. I agree with that. In fact, my wife and I were talking recently about a turn of events that particular day didn't go like we wanted them to. As we're going to bed, I said to my wife, she's the one that comes up with these, but I had to have this. I said, you know what? Tomorrow's a brand new day, and this could all change. And it's the same thing in football. The next, they beat Missouri, something happens. And I hate to say, use the Yogi Berraism, but it's not over till it's over. And even though a fan has to hang on to some kind of hope, as one has been in this business for a long time, over a half a century covering sports and whatever, I can only tell you that just when you think it's not going to happen, it happens both ways, not just the bad, but the good. So you have to hang in there, even though it was awfully tough after Saturday, wasn't it?
Definitely real tough. And, I like sports the same reason Azim does, life lessons. And, looking on paper, Muschamp's got strong pedigree. He was the successor to Mack Brown in Texas. The way he came and was a walk-on at Georgia, right?
Yes,
buddy?
He was. And a captain on defense later
on. Defense, exactly. He's undersized. He sold drinks at Florida Field. I mean, on paper, his brother's a West Point grad. But it's those inches, and it, just like in business sometimes, we could be that few inches off, and you say, man, it's the penalty for being a few inches off, buddy, whether it's sports or it's severe, and it's not fair sometimes.
And sometimes life is not fair, as we know. We all tell our children that sometimes. But anyway, so it's a tough one for Gator fans to swallow. I know you guys I know you were also there on the shores of Lake Weir when we had our little barbecue, and people before the season started and raised their hand and said, through all kinds of weather, we'll all stick together, So there you go. And here it is, that weather has come upon us. Let's shift gears for a second. Let's talk about your background here and you're growing up here, going to school here, being a part of the community and going to the University of Florida. and decided to stick around here and get into business. And now you have a successful business in HDG Hotels, and you're really getting involved now. I notice more and more by your posts and a lot of things you're doing in the community. Let's talk about, because we have this topic a lot on the show, what was it about this community that got you to stay in it and not go someplace else?
You know, we come from a family of dreamers, and you need money to, you know, if you dream, but you need the capital. And we lived on Long Island, and we had, my parents had the dreams of getting into the hotel business, but they couldn't afford to purchase anything on Long Island. And of course, they brought us to Disney World, and they liked Orlando, but at the end of the day, Ocala offered us the most opportunity for the money, the most bang for the buck, in terms of housing, in terms of getting into business, in terms of lesser regulation, into having a community also that was receptive to entrepreneurship. So that's what made Ocala our home.
And that was what year?
We moved here July 27th, 1981.
There you go. There you go. And what age were you guys then? You were in what? You're going to school, and what?
Yeah, I know. I started eighth grade at Grace Episcopal, and you started fifth grade, right, Izzy?
Or fourth grade?
Fourth grade.
No. Yep.
Yeah. Well, you knew it was going to be a great day, buddy. July 27th, 1981.
Yeah.
That's the 15th anniversary of the greatest day on the face of the earth. So you knew they were going to have success.
Go ahead, Tom.
Well, that's my birthday, yeah. So you know it's going to be a success. Wow.
They were able to overcome that. So that's interesting because, again, the paradigm for this kind of thing. My best friend in life came from Canada at 15 years old. His parents brought him down here, and they bought a motel on Silver Springs Boulevard. And I never met him, but someone told him there was a guy that lived two blocks down the street. When I came home from football practice, he was sitting on my steps, and he was eating an orange. From Canada. He knew a lot of, didn't know much about our culture at all around here. So we began hanging out. All these years, we're still best friends after that. So later, his dad built a couple of hotels, one called the Pan American, which is out on four, at one point, another one, the Shangri-La. He built a couple of those bigger hotels, or motels, as they call them those days. So tell me about HDG, and you guys have just keep expanding, and you have yourself, you have nine total businesses now, or is it more? Has it grown since I talked to you?
it's nine.
Nine, okay.
Yeah.
Nine, and explain to folks, I've mentioned a couple of times today about Holiday Inn Express at Silver Springs, and Sleep Inn and the Bellevue exit, and then a Hojo on 27 and exit of I-75. Talk about those, and also about the other six, where they are, and what you're doing there.
Okay. I'll start with our Marion County properties, and then Azeem will talk about some of our properties outside of Marion County. Of course, Howard Johnson's our flagship. That's the property my parents purchased in 1981. It's orange and blue. It still, I think, offers the best $60 room in Ocala. It's got 1,100 square foot of frontage. It's the first hotel that you see coming into Ocala. And then we purchased some property through Don Garlitz at the Don Garlitz Museum. That was our second property right off the interstate. So coming from the south, the first property hotel you'll see in Ocala is an HDG property, our Sleep Inn. And coming from the north are Howard Johnson's. And then we had an opportunity to build a Holiday Inn Express in Silver Springs. And it kind of tied us a little bit with the community because we were on the interstate, but now we got kind of in the community. And then we learned about the ecotourism of Ocala, and we really have worked that. And then we were outside of Ocala, too.
Yeah, we added a property in Wildwood. The real estate, my parents had a red carpet there that unexpectedly burned down in April of 2001. We sat on the real estate for a while and then went on a growth spurt, really starting from 03, 04, and we added the Sleep Inn in Wildwood. We added a Hampton Inn in Leesburg. We partnered with the Leesburg community over there to do that project. We added both of our Holiday Inns, one by Silver Springs, as Nevers had mentioned, and the other one in Inverness, Lecanto. And we thought we were really smart, but tying into the theme of resilience, as these new hotels opened up, the economy, went tanked pretty badly.
Oh, you mean you didn't see that coming? Like anybody did?
We opened up, as a note on that, we opened up our Hampton Inn in Leesburg the day the market crashed. Oh. Yeah.
So timing is everything in life, isn't it?
Yeah, we had to be resilient.
Yes, you did. And you have Titusville, right?
Correct. We then, in November of 2009, added a Quality Inn in Titusville, a big success story over there. The community, the shuttle launches were ending. The property had about 40% of its room inventory out of order, had four employees. In about a 12-month period, we grew revenues by over 60%.
Wow.
We added 20-plus jobs. We got all the rooms back online. The property went from being ranked in the bottom 10 of 1,000 or so Quality Inns to rounding out the top 35%.
Nice.
Yeah, and it kind of, the downturn and, you know, taught us about resilience. It taught us about being opportunistic also.
Yep, and then of course the relationships, you know. It really taught Azeem and me to develop good, honest relationships. Yeah. And then the same lender that gave us the Quality Inn in Titusville also had a similar situation in Newport Richey.
So you took the property
We took
there.
That over there. Similar, you know, half the hotel shut down. We've grown revenues there by 30%. And then we had a private equity group find out about us and invested in one of our properties in Hernando, the Quality Inn.
Nice. Well, that's good. Now, we come back. We're getting ready to take a break here. We'll talk about the future of this area, particularly the three here in Marion. Mm-hmm. I know I sat in with you a number of times. Now, Russ, I don't think Azeem was there. We talked about Save Our Silver Springs group mm-hmm. that we worked for a year. And let's talk about the future, the Silver Springs, particularly economic development, which you guys are a big part of. And get your take on it as businessmen about what you see, what you like to see change. And if you're dreaming, we'll dream a little bit too, all right? Coming up next, more with the Sajer Brothers right here in the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Being the Culligan man is not easy because he works hard every day for you here in North Central Florida. Whether you need bottled water delivery for your office, a home water softener, or water infiltration system, the Culligan Man can help you. At Culligan North Florida, we have dozens of softener and filtration options, along with a host of media tank sizes. Depending on the exact hardness and usage of your water, we determine the size of softener you're going to need. And if you're on city or well water in one of our local areas, the in-home water analysis is absolutely free. If your needs are for the home, call Ocala Water Conditioning, 352-291-5900. For home or business bottled water in Ocala, call Ocala Bottled Water, 352-291-5900. Culligan of North Florida, a proud sponsor of Florida State Football, heard right here on WOCA, The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. Educating healthcare workers is a must in the U.S. fight against Ebola, says the CDC.
We will double down on training
outreach, education, and assistance throughout the healthcare system.
Director Dr. Thomas Frieden, a Texas nurse who'd been treating the now deceased victim Thomas Duncan's being treated for the virus in the same hospital. U.S.-led airstrikes against ISIS forces around the town of Kobani may be working.
CENTCOM confirming seven more today, as Turkey is now denying an earlier Washington claim that it has given the U.S. permission to conduct those strikes from its bases.
Fox's Greg Palcott. Tornado warnings are up for much of Arkansas and the southern plains.
Forecasters say weather could get worse today, telling folks in Little Rock, Memphis, and Nashville to pay attention, with tornado watches and warnings extending in the overnight hours from the Gulf Coast to the Ohio Valley.
Fox Radio's Jeff Manasso. Fox News, we report, you decide.
You've packed your family of eight in a five-person car. Packed a week's worth of groceries into one bag. And when your wife says the dishwasher's full, you just laugh. But are you up for the challenge when there's 20% off on the line? Pick up our exclusive 5-gallon Napa Camo Bucket for just $2.99. Then get 20% off all the stuff you can fit in it. Conquer the job with Napa Know-How. At participating Napa Auto Parts stores while supplies last. Some exclusions apply. Offer expires 11/16/14.
Let's get down to business. You don't travel too often for work, but when you do, you want to stay where you know you'll be taken care of. That's where Choice Hotels comes in. We have everything you need to keep you on top of your game, like free hot breakfast for that much-needed morning boost, free internet to keep you in touch with home base, and a generous loyalty program so you can earn great rewards. Stay for business at Choice Hotels and book now at choicehotels.com. Great endings begin here. Amenities vary by location.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com. Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Back on The Voice of Ocala with Navras and Azim Saju, who've been here since 1981, now have a business here, HDG Hotels, three of which are here around the state, and I have the feeling they're going to be growing. When we, right before break, fellas, we talked about the future of Marion County, where we are and what we need to do and where we're going. And I know that, Navras, in your case, you were heavily involved in a couple of things, including hosting the Save the Silver Springs Committee that met for a year. I don't know that we had any impact, but we met. We tried. And also, I know you're on the tourism board and what, CEP, whatever. So talk about it, both of you, about how you feel where we are in our county. Are we visionary enough? Do we have the means, the ability to finance what we need to get done? And are we on the right track? Both of you comment on that, would you?
Okay, I'll go ahead and start. I think tourism, I mean, tourism is the U.S.'s largest export. This year, 94 million people are going to visit the state of Florida. And within this tourism, the subsegment of agrotourism and ecotourism is the largest growing segment, which is Marin County's wheelhouse. So tourism does represent a tremendous economic opportunity for Marin County. Are we doing enough to drive residents here? We're very strong with a lot of amateur sports. Our Marin County Parks and Recs do a great job, with all the parks and recs. Of course, we're endowed with Juniper Springs, Rainbow Springs, Salt Springs, Silver Glen Springs, the Silver River, Silver Springs. So we do have a lot of natural endowment here.
Blue Run. Rainbow Run, yeah.
Rainbow Run. I mean, the zip lining now. I mean, the equestrian events during the winter with hits. And year to date, Marin County, the demand for hotel rooms has exceeded the supply by over 5%.
So really?
People are definitely visiting Marin County. But like anything, we can always do more because we are competing against other Florida counties that want a bigger and bigger piece of the puzzle. But to do more, we need money. Azeem, you want to add to that?
Yeah, I mean, I think that what Navarro said about leveraging off of our existing natural resources is huge. We have some existing natural resources that I think are hard to replicate in other counties. And to add to that is that the idea of staycations, meaning people traveling within the state, has also become a very big deal. And how we leverage off of our website, our videos, to promote that concept so that if someone's living in the Panhandle or on the west coast of Florida, and they're looking to do a 3-day or 2-day or 4-day staycation, Marion County comes first to mind.
And talking about leveraging on online video, our Marion County Visitors and Convention Bureau won an award. It's called the Flagger Award, very, very prestigious, because of their website and the effectiveness on their website. And on another point, you bring up Silver Springs. We could do a lot more with Silver Springs, but we're a lot better off at Silver Springs than we were when Palace ran it. Mm-hmm. It's Silver Springs is open. We don't have guests come and say, well, it's not open today, or the restrooms haven't been cleaned. It's open.
I can't see the spring. I can't walk out of the park.
Yeah, it's open. They got some private vendors, and they're doing the kayaks and canoe rentals. We had a concert there this last Saturday. Travis Tripp. So things are definitely better, but the potential at Silver Springs
is amazing.
But we're better than what we are when Palace was there.
Yeah. Let's talk for a second about just what you just said, and sort of group it together in one lump. We know the power that we could have in ecotourism with Silver Springs, Silver Springs Park, which is 5,000 acres, and then the entire Ocala National Forest, which is another 400 and some thousand acres. Mm-hmm. We've talked about that to a blue in the face, about this Silver Springs is the gateway to ecotourism, which we may not be all excited about it here, but I guarantee you in parts of this world, if they knew they could come here and see what's here, and you talk about animals and reptiles, they got them in a natural state. As we say, Disney World could do a lot of things. They can never do that. Mm-hmm. And so that's organic. It's here. It's part of it. A lot of people feel like we're keeping it to ourselves, and we should be talking about it more. As Mark Emery says, you know, you put a polar bear camera up and millions of people watch it. What would happen if you put up a camera with, you know, in the forest and saw live deer and bears everywhere, whatever. So Silver Springs is a big part of that. Then you've got the other things, the downtown area, which we had a really, really nice downtown. It's getting better all the time. I talked about it today, somebody about the town. We got that going for us. the natural beauty and resources of the land. You mentioned all the springs, whatever. Do we have the will? Do we have the vision? And do we have the leadership to make this happen?
Mm. In terms of
maximizing what we have, our resources.
Right. Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of great stuff happening downtown. They had the concert series last spring, which drove a tremendous amount of traffic. They had the first International Film Festival,
right,
which was terrific.
Coming up again, by the way, the fall, yeah. The Halloween one's coming up here.
Well, I mean, we had dinner right across the Marion Theater. I mean, it was we had people from all over the country staying at our Holiday Inn Express in Silver Springs. But, you know, the challenge with everything, buddy, is when you have a large group of people. And, you know, how do you get everyone aligned together? But we have a lot of well-intentioned people in the community. And that's why we are making progress in terms of downtown. I saw the Sprint building this morning. I mean, they're gutting out that Sprint
building. How about that? That's exciting,
isn't
it?
Yeah, that is exciting. I mean, the merchants, the restaurants, you got to call, I mean, Saturday evenings to make reservations at some of these restaurants downtown. I mean, but, you know, if you can get more alignment and everyone kind of pulling in the same direction, which is always the challenge, whether it's our business, whether it's at home, I mean, we could definitely do more. But we are making progress.
What I want to know from Azeem is it how much harder is it to run a group of hotels than to be a trial lawyer? And how does one get from being a trial lawyer to running motels and hotels?
Well, I thought by leaving the law and not actively trying cases anymore, my life would get less stressful.
Wrong.
Exactly. I tell people it's the same knot in my stomach that I used to have when I used to try cases. It's the same.
Yeah.
You have to have the passion, the dedication, put in the hours. The phone rings at odd times. The art of managing and, you know, dealing with people, whether it's our team members or guests or vendors, is always challenging. Making them understand your point of view and where you're coming from and balancing that with trying to advance your agenda is a big challenge. But I'm fortunate to have a great partner and leader in Navros, and that makes it doing what I do much better than practicing.
Well, that's nice. That's my next question. What's it like, brothers working together? A lot of high tension, you know, and difficulty. And look, everybody has disagreements. I don't care who you are, you know, best friends, brothers, whatever. You seem to be able to manage those pretty well, at least from the outside, you do.
Now, I'm blessed to have a partner because it is a rough world out there, mm-hmm. You know, and someone we can, and of course, we, you know, we have disagreements. I mean, everyone has disagreements, but, you know, ultimately, it doesn't take away from what the goal is. And that we're trying to, we got the same goals. And then we talk it through, you know.
So how was Davidson?
I love Davidson. I was, we were actually there. I went, when school got out, I went with my brother, my sister-in-law, Shayda, their two boys, Champ and Noah, and not coincidentally, my brother named his first son after me.
Really? So,
his name is really Azeem, and then my wife Naz and my daughter Serena, we all went up there for my 20th year class reunion. Davidson was great for me. Not only did it advance me intellectually, but it allowed me to permanently mix in and understand Southern culture.
Yeah. And that's a trip.
And I wouldn't have gotten that cultural education anywhere but for a place like Davidson. Yeah. And boy, did I need it.
it's a lesson, that's for sure, and a neat place. And how about Georgetown?
Georgetown, you know, I watched my dad and my mom get bullied, you know, not bullied through the paper, you know, getting sued and not being able to represent themselves. So I said, I'm going to become a lawyer, and I'm not going to let that happen to me. Mm-hmm. But there were some very, very bright people at Georgetown, and I kind of got an awakening on how smart people can be.
Smart characters out there lurking in the shadows as well.
Yeah.
Well, I just want to tell you how lucky we are to have both of them in our community, and it's so neat that two people who practice law now are in partnerships in this ATG Hotels project, and you're growing. And I want to publicly thank both of you for your participation in high school sports as one of the sponsors, the Gay Player of the Week. It's really essential. High school athletics is, you know, it's a battle out there right now to keep athletics going in high school level. So we're able to support them, and with people like you, I want to thank you for that. Now, here's the catch. We have a game called Fake and Factoid. It's fairly simple to play. The idea is to beat Tom like
a drum. Hold on. You want me to play against a Georgetown grad and a Davidson grad? I graduated from Georgia Southern.
Yeah,
I think I'm at a disadvantage here.
So we come back. If you guys are game, we just simply read a statement and you say fake or factoid, okay? And it's just a little game, and you're going to have to agree you can. And then at the end, after five questions, we will have what we call the number. Can you get the closest thing to a number? You up for this or not?
Let's do it,
Brian. No shot today.
You got no shots, right?
No shot.
All right, more Fake or Factoid with the Saju Brothers after this timeout on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Here in Florida, when you're looking to go to the beach, you've got hundreds of options. Theme parks, no shortage of options there either. But when it comes to home insurance, most companies have only one option. Allstate is different. Here in Florida, Allstate agents offer home insurance options from several companies, so they can help you get the coverage that's right for you. And they'll help you save on quality car insurance, too. For starters, safe drivers save 45% with Allstate. So before you settle for just one option, talk to someone with many home and car insurance options. Your local Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
Hi, this is Kevin McDonald, your local Allstate agent. To get your quote, please call us at 622-2333 or stop by one of our two Ocala locations.
Allstate has no financial responsibility to you for any home insurance policy you purchase and would not be responsible for any claims. Allstate does not make any representations or accept liability related to operations of home insurance companies, including but not limited to their financial conditions, subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Savings vary.
Men, do you know your testosterone level? Are you experiencing decreased energy levels or unusual sleeping problems? Have you noticed you have less strength or endurance, decreased sex drive, increased irritability or depression? If so, you may be experiencing problems with low testosterone. If you're interested in a free testosterone screening, please call Renstar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. Again, that number is 352-629-5800.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Are you tired of not using your home's outdoor space for entertaining or relaxation because of all the bugs and leaves? Consider adding a beautiful screen room or glass enclosure. We are Superior Aluminum and Design, a family-owned and operated business with 20 years' experience in the aluminum industry, and we are accredited by the Better Business Bureau. If you appreciate superior workmanship, call Superior Aluminum and Design at 817-8058 or visit us on the web at superioraluminumdesign.com.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
Hi, I'm Leah Caruso with Strive Rehabilitation, inviting you to join me Thursday at 11 a.m. for Health Matters. Ocala Health and Strive have teamed up to bring you the latest information on good health services available to you right here at home. This vital information will help you make informed decisions about your health. So don't forget to join me here at 11 a.m. Thursday. It's news you can use from Ocala Health, Strive, and your friends here at WOCA.
Got a Garden, and we've got a show for you, called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
You're listening to WOCA Ocala.
Final segment here with the Sasha Brothers. They're, I think we got them past. We're in recovery now on the Gator game, and I think they're thinking about things except other things besides 3rd and 25. So there is life after 3rd and 25. Azeem, you and I know you're smiling right now, but like the rest of the Gators, they're all hurting, and I can see why. It was a sad day for Navros for a lot of folks up there. So your final thoughts now on where we go from here? Not so much the Gators, but final thoughts on our community and how you're feeling. Obviously, you're investing in it, so you feel pretty optimistic.
We're very excited about Marion County. In the next 5 years, there's going to be 124 million people visiting the state of Florida. And Marion County is right in the center. We got FedEx. We got industry coming in here. And then all the ecotourism growth. So we're excited about Marion County.
You're positioned well. But are you positioned well enough to be able to handle fake or factoid? Wow, that's blowing my ears out. Here we go. The game of fake or factoid. I make the statement. You can say fake or factoid. We'll alternate who goes first.
So set up.
So Tom doesn't want, we want Tom to pull off his antics. I know his little games.
So
okay?
Set up.
Number one, fake or factoid. And Tom, you'll go first on this one. A few days before the World Cup in 1966 in England, the trophy was stolen and later found by a dog. Fake or factoid?
Yeah, we'll go with fact on that.
You'll go fact on
I
that?
I got no clue.
Okay. All right, he goes fact.
World Cup. I got no clue.
Shall
soccer.
I repeat it? You have it all right?
Fake.
Fake. All right. So both saying fake?
Yes, fake.
Both fake. Unfortunately, it's fact. Tom didn't have any idea. He just guessed on it as usual. Okay. Number two. Three of these and you're out, by the way. In the United States, deaf people have safer driving records than hearing people nationally. You go first, Azeem Navros, whoever wants to go. Fake or factoid? Shall I repeat it? You good with it?
Yeah, can you repeat it?
Yeah. In the United States, deaf people have safer driving records than people who hear well.
Fact.
This is fact, Tom?
Fact.
Both say fact? Both correct. It's fact. Number three, among dogs, German Shepherds have the best eyesight. Tom?
Fact.
Fake.
Fake. And the correct answer is fake. The game is tied, gentlemen. Here we go. Number four.
Well, what dog? Never mind.
I don't know. That's not part of the question.
Never mind.
Number four. People are more allergic to yellow cats than gray, white, or black ones. Fake or factoid? I think it's the size you brothers to go first.
Can you repeat it again?
Yes. People are more allergic to yellow cats than they are gray, white, or black cats.
Fact.
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 Both say fact? Both wrong. It's fake. It's down to the last question, ladies and gentlemen. Who goes first?
I do.
There are more parrots.
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 Like the bird. P-A-R-R-O-T.
As pets, than there are fish, monkeys, and parakeets combined.
Fake.
Fake.
Repeat the question.
There are more parrots as pets than fish, monkeys, and parakeets combined.
Fake.
It is fake. Down to the final number. The number is this. For her 8th birthday, the actress Shirley Temple had how many gifts? Quickly. How many gifts? Tom, go first.
750.
750 gifts. How many gifts did Shirley Temple get for her 8th birthday? Shirley Temple.
980.
980, you win. It's actually, the number is 135,000.
Wow.
Massage your brothers. Thank you, gentlemen. Great job. Talk to you soon. Their winner is right here. Sports coming up next right here on The Source.
When you were a kid, you had all sorts of toys. Toy cars, boats, trucks, entire toy boxes full of fun. Of course, you never really outgrow your toys, do you? It's just that now, instead of a box full, you have a garage full. Cars, trucks, boats, motorcycles, ATVs, and more. As you get older, your love of toys just gets stronger. So protect those toys the best way possible by switching to Allstate. An Allstate agent can help do the switching, paperwork, bundle all your policies together, and even find you a bunch of discounts. So if you love your toys, make sure you protect your toys by making one call to an Allstate agent.
Protect all your toys with Allstate and the McDonald Agency. Established in 1985, we have offices in Ocala and the Villages to better serve you. Give us a call at 622-2333. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability.
Are you in good hands?
I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
Located next door to Silver Spring State Park and a few minutes from historic downtown Ocala, our award-winning Holiday Inn Express Hotel and Suites of Silver Springs is the place to stay for a friendly, memorable, and fun experience. Enjoy our fast and free Wi-Fi, complimentary hot breakfast, and free parking. Whether you're in town for work or play, our friendly staff will make you feel right at home. That's the Holiday Inn Express and Suites of Silver Springs. Proud sponsor of Friday night Marion County High School football on WOCA, The Source.
Yeah, Lance?
Yes, George?
I'm royalty at Devon Self Storage now on Highway 200 across from Hobby Lobby. It says right here in this letter.
George, I read that letter too, and it's Devon's loyalty rewards. Pay 3 months in advance, get 5% off. Pay 6 months in advance, get 7% off. Pay 12 months in advance and get 10% off.
See, Alice, Devon Self Storage treats me like royalty. Just call them at 873-0777.
Yes, George, yes.
I'm Major George Patterson from the Salvation Army. Please stop by our family store at 120 Northwest 10th Street in Ocala, where on Wednesday you have a 50% off clothing and bric-a-brac. On Friday, 25% off furniture and large appliances. And on Saturday, stop by to our yard sale from 8:45 to 11. Donations can be made by calling 352-732-4469 and we'll pick it up. Funds from the store go toward the services that we provide in Marion County.
What you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Talking about ourselves stimulates the brain the same way love, food, and cash do. Everybody's favorite subject is themselves. So, on a date, ask her about herself. Adults studying a new language learn words and phrases faster when they sing them. Normal, happy cows produce about 9 gallons of milk a day. But super relaxed and happy cows produce more than 10 gallons.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information-hungry, better-educated, high-income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370 WOCA.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. Trying to ease public fears about Ebola, the director of the biocontainment unit at the Nebraska Medical Center says they have protocols in place to prevent its spread.
There's a step-by-step instruction guide, and we have visual cues on the wall. We also have a single individual whose job is to help somebody put on and take off the personal protective equipment.
Shelley Schwedhelm, an Ebola-infected NBC cameraman's being treated at the center. The virus having an effect on Wall Street.
Ebola is working its way into the minds of investors and traders. They're scared.
Fox Business Network's Adam Shapiro, the Dow dropped 222 points, closing at 16,321. Health officials warning of the enterovirus, which is sick in hundreds in 46 states, mainly children.
Dr. Matthew Davis with the Michigan Department of Community Health explains when parents should call the doctor.
Having some difficulty moving their arms or legs, or if you're worried that they're having more difficulty breathing.
Fox Radio's Rachel Sutherland reporting. Fox News, we report, you decide.
You've packed your family of eight in a five-person car, packed a week's worth of groceries into one bag, and when your wife says the dishwasher's full, you just laugh. But are you up for the challenge when there's 20% off on the line? Pick up our exclusive 5-gallon Napa Camo Bucket for just $2.99, then get 20% off all the stuff you can fit in it. Conquer the job with Napa Know-How. At participating Napa Auto Parts stores while supplies last. Some exclusions apply. Offer expires 11/16/14.
Let's get down to business. You don't travel too often for work, but when you do, you want to stay where you know you'll be taken care of. That's where Choice Hotels comes in. We have everything you need to keep you on top of your game, like free hot breakfast for that much-needed morning boost, free internet to keep you in touch with home base, and a generous loyalty program so you can earn great rewards. Stay for business at Choice Hotels and book now at choicehotels.com. Great endings begin here. Amenities vary by location.
I'm a shark. 30. 30 seconds. I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho. Ho, ho, ho.
And now it's time for the
Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
It's like I don't fit in. It's like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poll house at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now,
here's Buddy.
Hello, welcome to a Monday edition of Buddy Sports Page. Beautiful day outside. Football, football, football. Plenty to talk about this weekend. Lots of stories to sort of digest. We're still looking back at the Jameis Winston situation, about him facing disciplinary hearing, possible suspension, although it looks to me like this is a lot of things that are warmed over from the last report. But we'll weigh in on that situation. Jimbo Fisher, not too happy with the media today. Kind of jumping on them about their questions regarding what he thinks about the case and whether it's been accurately portrayed in the media. We'll discuss that. Treon Harris is back. He will split time with Jeff Driscoll this weekend, as I suspected he might. And how about them Dallas Cowboys? Who would have thought they'd go out to Seattle and beat the Seahawks as they did? In this hour also, we'll focus on the big game in Tallahassee. Top five game, the number two ranked Seminoles. Yes, they fell from number one, as you know by now, against the number 5 Notre Dame Fighting Irish. And in this hour, we'll talk to the man who covers the team regularly for WarChant.com. Irish Schofield joins us at 5:15. And at 5:35, John Finneran, former assistant sports editor of the South Bend Tribune, who now lives in South Bend, will weigh in on the Irish, finished off by Franz Beard of FightingGators.com. A jam-packed hour for you, Tom. Here's the headlines with Tom.
New York Giants. Let me turn my mic on.
If I turn my mic on, it always works better. New York Giants wide receiver Victor Cruz is out for the season. Coach Tom Coughlin said Monday that Cruz will need surgery to repair a torn patella tendon in his right knee. He did not know when the surgery would be performed or the length of rehabilitation. So Victor Cruz out for the New York Giants for the season. Jimbo Fisher said Florida State's Jameis Winston has committed no crime and is adamant the quarterback will not miss any games this season due to an ongoing sexual assault investigation. Fisher said Monday recent reports about the investigation hadn't revealed anything new. This country is based off being innocent until proven guilty, not guilty until you're proven innocent. Fisher said, no, there's no victim because there was no crime. We're convicting a guy over things that are not true based on evidence. So Jimbo Fisher got the back of his quarterback at Florida State. North Carolina State has suspended 7 players, including the leading tackler and a second defensive starter for this week's game against Louisville, for their involvement in a BB gun incident, Coach Drew Doran said Monday. Doran said the players were playing a game with a BB gun at an off-campus residence last week and made a mistake as not recognized this activity could have resulted in someone being injured. The coach provided no further details. Raleigh Police Department spokesman Jim Sergu did not immediately return an email. So they're suspended for a BB gun incident. 7 players from North Carolina State. And finally, the polls are out, buddy.
What is this BB gun thing?
Oh, who knows? Finally, the polls are out this week. The AP Top 25, like you said, Mississippi State at number 1 with 45 first-place votes. Florida State falls to number 2 with 12 first-place votes. Ole Miss, University of Mississippi, gets 3 first-place votes and is 3rd. Baylor 4, Notre Dame 5, Auburn, Alabama, Michigan State, Oregon, and Georgia round out the top 10. In the coaches' poll, Mississippi State once again, 26 first-place votes, and they're in first place. Florida State in 2nd place with 31 first-place votes, but not enough votes to get up first. Mississippi with 5 first-place votes. Baylor and Notre Dame round out that top 5. Michigan, Alabama, Auburn, Oregon, and Georgia. Michigan State, Alabama, Auburn, Oregon, and Georgia also round out that top 5. There's your headlines. But I do have a juicy story for you if you got a minute.
Yeah, first of all, this just in. Franz Beard says he's reporting this. He's going to be with us at 5:50. He says Jameis Winston did sign 340 articles for an autograph seller.
Jameis Winston?
Jameis Winston. But he says Jimbo says he didn't take any money for it.
Okay. All right.
So there you go.
And by the way, as long as he doesn't take any money for it.
The autograph seller guy made money. These guys are scum.
They are scumbags. Not every autograph seller is a scumbag, but this guy, the guy that with Todd Gurley, who, by the way, is a Florida fan. We'll get into that later. It's a mess.
And by the way, he says he didn't take any money for it. Let's just hope that doesn't surface later. Because the first thing you think was, okay, is Jameis Winston taking a lie detector test? How does he know?
I don't know.
So anyway, one good note here, a vicious hit and a really scary moment on the Troy Pittman in the LSU game. Carted off the field. Everybody held their breath. You saw there were players hurt from both sides. LSU players came on the field, nailed down, prayed. It was a very scary moment in the game. Apparently he's okay, and now the word is he might even play. So that's good news for our guy from Citra, Northern Aaron, LaTroy Pittman. We're glad to hear that. So very, very important. One final thought about this and let you do your Daniel Snyder story, which I'm going to talk about. This is a time when the pressure gets turned up. All of a sudden, coaches are getting a little bit feisty. It wears on you.
It does.
It wears on you. I know some coaches. I was around one recently, as you know. You can see the strain on the faces of the coaches and their spouses, by the way. It is a brutal business. Yes, they get paid lots of money, but when you don't win football games, or even if you win them barely, or even if you win them all, today is proof that Jimbo Fisher, who's been a pretty cool customer, feeling the heat, fired back at the media. Nick Saban, Mr. Cool, came a bit unglued today in his press conference, talking about the fact we won the game 14-13. You guys, I'm angry because we played hard, we played well. Just because we didn't win by a big score, you know, you're devaluing our team, da 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 da. You could see the veins on his neck. You can see the pressure.
A lot of people say Nick Saban and Lane Kiffin may not be the best couple that everybody thinks
might not, because the offense is having problems right now.
Right.
And then you add in, the odd thing about it is the guy who's handling the best, Will Muschamp.
Will Muschamp, yeah.
If anybody ever had a right to be really upside down and crazy, he's got it.
It's kind of like that old Looney Tunes cartoon, though, buddy, where Yosemite Sam, every time he said a cuss word or something, Bugs Bunny took money away from him. And at the end, he said, look, rabbit, I got it kicked. And they're kicking him and hitting him and throwing things in his face. And the rabbit looks at him and goes, I just don't have to, looks at the screen and goes, I just don't have the heart to tell him he's out of money. I kind of got that feeling about Will Muschamp.
Speaking of money.
Daniel Snyder, man loaded with it. And, you know, he's got this controversy going on about the racial connotations about the name Washington Redskins.
Yes, he does.
Well, Dan Snyder may have won some points that Sunday. Points about keeping his name Redskins. As the Navajo Nation president, Ben Shelley, joined Snyder in the owner's box for the Redskins game against the Arizona Cardinals. The Navajo Nation covers more than 27,000 square miles of Arizona, Utah, and New Mexico. It's the largest Native American reservation in the United States. More pointedly, the Navajo Nation is home to Red Mesa Arizona High School, a Native American-based school. Guess what their name is?
Redskins.
The Redskins. Last year, a spokesman for Shelley indicated the Navajo Nation supported the use of the name throughout the entire Navajo community. The Navajo community is the largest community, the largest Native American-based community in existence inside the United States.
Well, there you go.
Dan Snyder may have an ally that says the Redskins' name is not a bad thing, and this is a man who leads the largest Native American population in the country.
He's not going to quit on this.
He's pushing back just as hard as people are saying it's racist, and now it looks like he's got the Navajo Nation president on his side. And like I said, the Navajo Nation president he's the president of the largest Native American contingent in the United States.
All right, let's take a break, come back. We'll be joined by the managing editor of WarChant.com, talking some FSU football, Jimbo Fisher. Irish Schofield was at the press conference to see what he says about Jimbo's temperament. All coming up next right here on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Here in Florida, when you're looking to go to the beach, you've got hundreds of options. Theme parks, no shortage of options there either. But when it comes to home insurance, most companies have only one option. Allstate is different. Here in Florida, Allstate agents offer home insurance options from several companies, so they can help you get the coverage that's right for you. And they'll help you save on quality car insurance, too. For starters, safe drivers save 45% with Allstate. So before you settle for just one option, talk to someone with many home and car insurance options. Your local Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
Hi, this is Kevin McDonald, your local Allstate agent. To get your quote, please call us at 622-2333 or stop by one of our two Ocala locations.
Allstate has no financial responsibility to you for any home insurance policy you purchase and would not be responsible for any claims. Allstate does not make any representations or accept liability related to operations of home insurance companies, including but not limited to their financial conditions, subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Savings vary.
Imagine yourself in a quaint bistro right in the heart of a charming French village about to indulge in real French cuisine. Located in beautiful, vibrant downtown Ocala, La Cuisine offers authentic French cuisine and wine from an award-winning menu. Patrice and Elodie moved to Ocala in 2009 because they fell in love with it. And you're going to fall in love with La Cuisine if you haven't already. La Cuisine offers a quick bite for lunch or a leisurely dinner in a comfortable and relaxed setting. So call La Cuisine of Ocala today at 352-433-2570. It's like a direct call to Paris.
Eye Care Center of Ocala is centered on patient satisfaction. Our friendly doctors and staff are here to serve all of your family's eye care needs under one roof. Our optometric physicians take great pride in offering every patient the absolute best in vision care, utilizing state-of-the-art technology. We're located about 2 miles west of I-75 on State Road 200. You can schedule an appointment for the Eye Care Center by going to www.eyecarecenterofocala.com, or you can call us at 352-512-0560.
Hello, Mr.
everybody. This is Terry Bradshaw, Fox NFL Sunday. Whenever I'm in Ocala, if I'm not picking and singing with my buddy Mel Tillis, then I'm listening to my longtime friend Buddy Martin on WOCA. Of course, I rarely get to Ocala, so if you believe that, I've got some horses I'd like to sell you. Some of them even have four legs. Regardless, I highly recommend you listen to Buddy Martin's Sports Page weekdays at 5 p.m. right here on The Source.
Look who just walked in the room, Joel Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey, Joel, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joel, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah, whatsupocala.com.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
Saturday mornings at 9 a.m. right here on The Source, WOCA. Don't miss Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with your hosts, Francois Cousinet and Julianne Cousinet. They'll be giving you information about your retirement funds and answering your questions with live call-in. So don't miss it. Saturdays from 9 a.m. till 10 a.m., Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM, 1370 AM.
A garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
WOCA.
On Saturday, the Florida State University Seminoles play a game against Notre Dame. It didn't look all that big last summer. However, now it becomes a huge game because it involves two top five teams. They're now number two ranked Seminoles, number five ranked Irish. And I don't think Ira Schofield, when he signed on to become managing editor of Warchant.com, even saw this one coming. Am I right, Ira?
No, I didn't. I didn't expect Notre Dame to be quite this good. I mean, we knew they had lost a good bit, and you know, I like Golson as a quarterback, but I didn't know he took a year off. He thought there might be some rust, and then obviously last week when they fell behind early against North Carolina, you thought, okay, well, this thing may not be that big of a deal, but they pulled it out, and like you said, now you got a top five matchup, FSU and Notre Dame, and kind of seems like old times.
How big a game is this at Doak Campbell on Saturday?
It's very big because, you know, I think if you look back earlier this season when FSU played Clemson, that was, you know, everybody thought that was going to be the big game. Game day was going to be here, and Clemson, people were real excited about Clemson maybe being the best defensive team in the ACC and Florida State being the best offensive team in the ACC. But that game, you know, really lost its luster when Clemson lost to Georgia and got blown out in the second half by Georgia. And then Jameis Winston was suspended, so he couldn't play, so he lost that. And then it kind of lost some of what it was supposed to be. Now, I think Florida State fans are getting that big game excitement that they probably missed out on against Clemson.
Opening game 37-31, not really impressive, but enough to keep the Seminoles ranked number one. You go through, and then you had the overtime game at Clemson. But now, since that time, you kind of owned the, I say not you because you aren't suited up, but the Seminoles have kind of owned their opponents, including last weekend a game 38-20 in the Carrier Dome, which is not against a great team, but it's kind of a tough place to play. As the Seminoles come out of this game, regarding things on the field right now, what kind of shape are they in to face the Notre Dame Fighting Irish, their fifth-ranked Irish, in this game?
Well, you know, I mean, I think the most important thing is, like you said, they've found ways to win, and they've won somewhat convincingly the last few weeks. I think the reason Florida State fans aren't super confident is really in every game there's been a part of the game where they didn't play real well. You know, I think last year Florida State was so dominant on both sides of the ball, and they would, you know, blow teams out, and that's not happening. You know, either against Wake Forest, the offense was kind of out of sorts. They couldn't score in the red zone. It was 16-3 midway through the second half. They ended up winning it by 40 points, but it was kind of a ugly game for about three quarters. And then even, you know, the NC State game, they got down big. They had to rally to come back and win. And then against Syracuse, they played really well offensively. Jameis was 30 of 36, and the running game looked good. But then defensively, they let Syracuse kind of go up and down the field and, you know, rack up over 400 yards of offense. And so I think every game there's been something that FSU hasn't looked good in. So for that reason, I think people feel like they're still kind of vulnerable, especially once they start playing better teams.
A lot of news over the weekend, naturally, all the big New York Times story. There are those who think that obviously the Tallahassee police were complicit in this and have not been taking care of their responsibilities. There's another group that says, hey, this is just the same stuff repackaged by the New York Times. How do you come down on this, Ira Schoffel?
You know, I think as far as Jameis goes, you know, it was a lot of the same stuff. I mean, the New York Times story had a couple of things, other incidents that, you know, had previously gone unreported. No charges were filed at the time, and I think that's kind of what their allegation was, is that the Tallahassee police basically won't aggressively pursue charges against FSU athletes. The problem with that theory, though, is what they don't mention in that story is, you know, in the last 10 years, there's been more than 10 FSU football players arrested for different things. And that's not something anybody's proud of. Certainly, FSU is not going to put out a press release saying, look at all the guys we actually have had arrested. But the reality is, I mean, Greg Reed, when he was their best defensive back and punt returner, he got arrested for something that turned out to be not a big deal, and they ended up having to drop the charges. Greg Dent, the wide receiver, of course, was charged with sexual battery. They've had, you know, other players, you know, had run-ins and were charged right away. Jameis, again, you know, I think the point a lot of FSU people try to make, and no one wants to listen to him, is, you know, Jameis was a high-profile recruit, but he wasn't, you know, the Heisman Trophy winner. Most people, including me, didn't expect him to start that next season. So I don't think there was a grand conspiracy, and I don't think anything's come out to say that. But it seems like, you know, obviously the media certainly wants to hammer that point home that it was a conspiracy.
I have another report from ESPN here today which says that Jameis Winston signed 340 articles for an autograph seller, but Jimbo Fisher says, I guess in his press conference, that Jameis didn't take any money for it. What do you know about that, and what can you shed, kind of light can you shed on that statement?
Yeah, I mean, that's really just kind of come out of the Gurley investigation because, you know, these autographs were, I mean, there's a million Jameis Winston autographs out there because, you know, FSU played 60 or 70 college baseball games, and he would sign for about an hour before and after every game. So there's a ton of baseballs and footballs and hats and helmets and everything else out there. Nobody's really surprised by that. But the fact that, you know, I guess, you know, the 300 and however many were authenticated by this broker or whatever you call a memorabilia collector, dealer, they were authenticated by the same guy that authenticated a lot of the Gurley ones. That raises a red flag, and so FSU is apparently reportedly investigating it. But, you know, the difference in the Gurley case and the Florida State case right now is the Gurley case, somebody was telling them that he paid them for the signatures. He was paid for the signatures and said he had video of Gurley signing them after receiving payment. You know, with Winston, as far as we know right now, nobody's made that allegation. They just, there are autographs out there. So, you know, we'll have to see what happens. I mean, FSU certainly has to investigate it, but right now there aren't even any charges that he got paid for it.
Are you surprised that Winston has played so well in view of the criticism he's received this season? A fact that Jimbo Fisher brought up in his press conference, he gives him credit for that. Do you?
I'm not surprised by it because he did it last year. You know, I thought, last year, I mean, that when that news broke, he went out and played great the next week when the allegation first surfaced. And I, I was amazed he did it then. I've been amazed ever since, but it doesn't seem like anything new. I mean, I watch him in pregame warmups, and he calls the football field his sanctuary and all that. I mean, he clearly is one of those people that when he starts playing a game or starts competing, he doesn't think about anything else. And I mean, that's a credit, and Jimbo Fisher said it was a credit. It's also a little weird. I don't think most people can do that. I certainly wouldn't be able to do that. I know just in my normal job, if I've got something going on at home, it's hard to not take it to work. So I don't know how he does it, but it doesn't surprise me anymore because he's done it time and time again.
I don't mean this in a criminal sort of way, but the irony is they say great cornerbacks in the NFL have to have no conscience and no memory, when they get beat deep. So in a different kind of way, Jameis Winston seems to have that going for him. Here's the amazing thing. If I would have told you that Florida State would be 22 straight wins to their credit and not be number one, ranked number one in the country halfway through the season, would you believe that?
No, that is, it's a little bit surprising. And I think, Jimbo talked about that today at his press conference. Said, look, he's not too surprised because of, obviously Mississippi State has played well, but he thinks that, if FSU beats Notre Dame, a top five Notre Dame team, there's a good chance FSU will go back up there to the top spot. I've looked back and over the years, there have been teams, I think Florida, after winning the national title, at one point wasn't number one the next year. And it's not, unheard of. And the bottom line is FSU doesn't look like a flawless team. I think it would be unfair probably if FSU looked anything like it did last year. But other than on offense, where they do look pretty similar to last year, they don't look like the same team. So it's not really that surprising either.
Few injuries to play through, got a few dings here and there for the Seminoles, but otherwise they should be in good shape for the primetime game Saturday night on ABC. Ira Schofield, is going to be a good night. Doug Campbell, I'm sure you'll be there. Thanks for being on the program.
Thanks, buddy. Take care.
Ira Schofield from warchant.com. I do like the big game atmosphere. I do like that. That's one thing I miss in Gainesville. We haven't had many of those lately. But it's back when Florida was playing those big games, there's nothing quite. It's like a heavyweight fight. Have you ever been to a heavyweight fight before?
I have.
And you know there's that feeling you go that something special is going to happen.
There's like an excitement in the air.
There really is. And especially when the weather gets a little cool.
Right.
A night game, the lights are on. This means something, that kind of thing. So that's what they're going to have this weekend in Doak Campbell. Not so much this weekend for the Florida Gators, although it's a game that could put them in a lot better shape, obviously, and give them a little bit more credibility. And we found out from Georgia they are beatable in Columbia, Missouri.
Yeah. I like our good friend Justin Wells. He said what amazed him most Saturday night was there was no bitter disappointment or seething anger over the loss. It was an air of resignation. The setting the game of college football back a generation each Saturday is simply what we've been reduced to on a weekly basis in Gainesville.
Yeah, but it's been fantastic in terms of the national game setting. By the way, this weekend, South Carolina plays host to Furman. Texas A&M is at number 7, Alabama. Georgia, Arkansas, tough loss for the Razorbacks against Alabama. Florida, of course, plays Missouri, hosting Missouri. Tennessee and Ole Miss could be a good game, although I like Ole Miss pretty heavily. And oddly enough, in its own way, Kentucky LSU has a little bit of appeal.
That's a pretty good football game. I think that's going to be the most closely contested game.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting. And this whole SEC thing has been what an incredible result that's been with the SEC and what the ratings are getting, man. Amazing. Stay tuned. Coming up next, we'll talk Notre Dame with John Finneran, formerly of the South Bend Tribune, right here on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor.
saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Being the Culligan man is not easy because he works hard every day for you here in North Central Florida. Whether you need bottled water delivery for your office, a home water softener, or water infiltration system, the Culligan man can help you. At Culligan North Florida, we have dozens of softener and filtration options, along with a host of media tank sizes. Depending on the exact hardness and usage of your water, we determine the size of softener you're going to need. And if you're on city or well water in one of our local areas, the in-home water analysis is absolutely free. If your needs are for the home, call Ocala Water Conditioning, 352-291-5900. For home or business bottled water in Ocala, call Ocala Bottled Water, 352-291-5900. Culligan of North Florida, a proud sponsor of Florida State Football, heard right here on WOCA, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. Trying to ease public fears about Ebola, the director of the biocontainment unit at the Nebraska Medical Center says they have protocols in place to prevent its spread.
There's a step-by-step instruction guide, and we have visual cues on the wall. We also have a single individual whose job is help somebody put on and take off the personal protective equipment.
Shelley Schwedhelm, an Ebola-infected NBC cameraman's being treated at the center. The virus having an effect on Wall Street.
Ebola is working its way into the minds of investors and traders. They're scared.
Fox Business Network's Adam Shapiro, the Dow dropped 222 points, closing at 16,321. Health officials warning of the enterovirus, which has sickened hundreds in 46 states, mainly children.
Dr. Matthew Davis with the Michigan Department of Community Health explains when parents should call the doctor.
Having some difficulty moving their arms or legs, or if you're worried that they're having more difficulty breathing.
Fox Radio's Rachel Sutherland reporting. Fox News, we report, you decide.
You've packed your family of eight in a five-person car. Packed a week's worth of groceries into one bag. And when your wife says the dishwasher's full, you just laugh. But are you up for the challenge when there's 20% off on the line? Pick up our exclusive 5-gallon Napa Camo Bucket for just $2.99. Then get 20% off all the stuff you can fit in it. Conquer the job with Napa Know-How. At participating Napa Auto Parts stores while supplies last. Some exclusions apply. Offer expires 11/16/14.
Let's get down to business. You don't travel too often for work, but when you do, you want to stay where you know you'll be taken care of. That's where Choice Hotels comes in. We have everything you need to keep you on top of your game. Like free hot breakfast for that much-needed morning boost. Free internet to keep you in touch with home base. And a generous loyalty program so you can earn great rewards. Stay for business at Choice Hotels and book now at choicehotels.com. Great endings begin here. Amenities vary by location.
On this episode of What Not to Do, brought to you by
Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
Honey.
In here.
Are you tearing up the bathroom? I thought we agreed to let Mike Scott Plumbing handle this on Monday.
Yeah, I know, but I got this. I watched a how-to video on YouTube.
Oh, well. So instead of calling the professionals at Mike Scott Plumbing, who, by the way, do this for a living, and wait, is that a jackhammer?
Yep, watch this. Let the master show you how it's done. Okay, we may have an ever so slight leaking problem.
Great job, Mr. Genius. Now you broke the water line.
No. That was like that when I got here.
Well, looks like the only thing you've mastered is the art of making a mess. So now I'm picking up the phone and calling Mike Scott Plumbing, who won't charge us extra for nights, weekends, or holidays.
No, wait. I can fix this. Just hand me that.
The only thing I'm handing you is the phone. No, wait. I'll handle this. 237-2888.
On next week's episode of What Not to Do.
The fire department.
Are you wasting hundreds or thousands of dollars on termite retreat fees? If you're not with Turner Pest Control, you probably are. Turner Pest Control offers the industry's only termite and pest control package that never charges retreat fees, ever. You can get started today for only $99. This is a value of $500 or more. This includes treatments, installation of monitoring stations, quarterly pest control, and a lifetime guarantee, all for an unbelievable low $99. Even if you have another pest control provider, visit TurnerPest.com to find out how you can avoid paying those high termite retreat fees.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Welcome back to Buddy Sports Radio. Just a moment, we'll be talking to John Fenner, former sports editor of the South Bend Tribune, who will share his thoughts about the upcoming game. We heard from Ira Schofield. I just want to talk a little about Saturday's game, Florida-LSU. Number one, if you haven't heard the news by now, Will Muschamp says he'll play both quarterbacks on Saturday. I think that's a good move. In fact, it's one I predicted to Tom Schmitz this morning would happen. He'll play them both. But there were certain parts of that game on Saturday. And by the way, it was intense the last 5.5 minutes. I mean, really intense. So many huge plays. And some interesting things that happened and some really heartfelt, heartbreaking things that happened. First of all, just the idea that on 3rd and 25, LSU hit a 41-yard pass completion from Jennings to Durrell, and then get a 15-yard face mask or hands to the face tacked on, which amounts to a 56-yard gain that late in the game. Wow. 3rd and 25. They've gone back on that one a lot of times, I'm sure. Will continue to busted coverage again.
10 people got it. One person didn't.
Great play. Now, on to the call, what I call the call.
I'm turning my microphone off so I don't say something.
When it happened, I was screaming at the television set. When LSU had the ball, advanced it, and the clocks were ticking off with no timeouts, and obviously Gator players were slow getting up. Yes, they were, no doubt about it. Suddenly, the official stops the clock and puts 7 seconds back on the clock. I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it. And then I talked to an SEC coach. It was not Muschamp, or it wasn't Miles, who really said, I've never seen that before. So I went to the next best source, a friend of mine who was an SEC replay official. I'm not going to say his name. I said, what is with this idea? Don't you either stop the clock and make the change then, or, you know, put the time back on, whatever. But you can't stop the clock and then put the time back. I mean, that rarely, if ever, happens. And I, the SEC coach being said to me, that's a brand new one. He's been around for a long time, by the way. So I asked the replay official about this play, which, of course, gave LSU 3 seconds to kick the field goal because they spiked the ball. Gave them 10 seconds to actually end up with time, enough time to spike the ball and get the field goal. He says, a little unprecedented. I'm not sure how you can be a little unprecedented, but the right thing to do with the delay tactics University of Florida is attempting. Okay. So that was a little confusing. I wrote back, but shouldn't they just have stopped the clock? He said, well, I guess so. He said, the only good thing they could have done that would have been better was just to stop the clock in a timely fashion. And that's all I'm saying. Now, did that cost them the game? No, it didn't cost them the game. But it did cost them in a big way. And there are other plays. And let's go back to the drop pass in the end zone First of all, let's not forget who got them down the field, all the way down on a beautiful bomb, 70-some yard pass completion to Robinson. And I said when he had the ball, you better score because you don't want to get down in the red zone because Florida's had trouble getting the ball in the end zone. Of course, what happens? Stopped at the two-yard line. Two tries, two runs. Third play, pass to the tight end. Pretty much right in the hands of the tight end. And, of course, for like the 18th time, dropped the ball. Dropped the ball. Dropped the touchdown. So, had that not happened, there would not have been the interception at the end when Driscoll threw the ball too hard to Troy Pittman. Pittman was hurt, and he wound up getting carted off the field. Thankfully, he's okay, and the ball was tipped and intercepted, and they got the ball and went in. Anyway, bizarre things happened in that game. There was the catch. There was the play. Third and 25, the call. And, of course, in the end, the pain. A lot of pain for Gator fans. We're going to go ahead and take a break right now and see if we can hook up with John Finneran next and come back and catch him on the other side. Get his view of Notre Dame, Florida State next, coming up on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Requires bank approval. Vehicle purchase price of fixed rate allowance.
Fumble. I was so busy making my fantasy football picks that I forgot to stock up on inventory, and now I need cars fast, so I'm calling for an inventory blitz. Chris Spears here from Prestige Auto Sales. This month, bring me in your old car, and you could score the nicer, newer ride you've been fantasizing about for just $10 down.
Sack your old car.
And start driving the nicer, newer car of your dreams for just $10 down. Don't get fouled by past credit problems.
Our For the People credit approval process is the game changer you've been waiting for.
We huddle up the banks and lenders to help you get approved and back in the game. So stop driving a car you hate.
Punt it and drive a nicer, newer car for just $10 down today.
I'm throwing in a Hail Mary to make my month, and I need your help. Trade in your old car, and you could drive for just $10 down. But don't wait till the clock runs out. This deal is over when my inventory is full. I'm Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit us at Prestige Auto Sales or call 694-1234. Yes, 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
Hi, this is Randy Briggs of the Briggs Law Firm. Traditional help for truly injured. We trademark registered this belief years ago as our description of our practice at the Briggs Law Firm. By traditional help, we mean that clients actually meet with a partner in the firm who will personally handle their case, not a paralegal. Well, what about truly injured? We limit our practice to injury claims having merit with clients who indeed have been injured. So if you or a loved one have been truly injured, compare our credentials at the Briggs Law firm.com or call us at 671-4600.
Hi, I'm Buddy Martin, the host of The Voice of Ocala, every weekday from 3 to 6 right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. A lot of people ask me, how do you keep a muzzle on Tom Schmitz? Forget about it. All right, we're going to end effort now to get a hold of John Finneran. We're kind of slammed in here the next couple of minutes. Get John's take on the Notre Dame-Florida State game. The top five game played at Doak Campbell Stadium. You heard from Ira Schofield earlier. It's a big game atmosphere up in Tallahassee, and there's a lot of things going on that are making the news. None of it really that good, as the Seminoles, who are won 22 consecutive games, try to keep that streak alive against a Notre Dame team that was better, is better than people thought. So we'll be joined just momentarily by John Finneran, former sports editor of the South Bend Tribune, to talk about that game and Golson, the quarterback, who's playing quite well these days. So we'll get John up. We've got John Finneran now. John Finneran from South Bend, Indiana. John Finneran, formerly of the South Bend Tribune, joins the program now. John, first of all, how are you?
Well, Budrow, I'm doing well. I have to get used to all this cold weather again. But the first game that I was back in town for was the Stanford game, and it was probably 45 degrees, rainy, drizzly, ucky, but I managed to get through it, so I guess I'll be okay.
All right, John.
I do.
John, just because of time, I want to get right to the game, and we're running a little bit behind right now. Saturday, the Florida State Seminoles won 22 in a row, playing in a game that most people didn't anticipate would have a major, be a major factor in the potential playoff scene. Now, all of a sudden, it's a top five game, and people are saying, you know what? Notre Dame, they got a pretty good quarterback named Golson. They also happen to have a pretty good defense, although they wouldn't own it by last Saturday. What kind of shape are the Fighting Irish in as they come to Doak Campbell Stadium on Saturday?
Well, I think you're going to see a pretty good Notre Dame team. I think they're relatively good shape. About the only person is Chris Collinsworth's son has a shoulder injury that they're still evaluating what to do with it. And he's a big factor on their. On their defense in the safety position. Notre Dame is defensively, they have, last week was an anomaly. They gave up 500 and some odd yards against a North Carolina team, which played an up-tempo game and which took Notre Dame out of the things they wanted to do as far as substituting and stuff. So prior to that, Brian Van Gorder, their new defensive coordinator, the team has been very – it's as quick a defense as I've seen a Notre Dame team ever have, buddy. And they run the ball, they force turnovers and things like that if they have the opportunity to make the substitutions that they want in the in the course of a game. Now, one name that's been very good defensively for Notre Dame is a kid by the name of Cody Riggs. Does that name sound familiar?
It does, former Gator.
Yep, and under the NCAA rules now, as you know, if you've used up your eligibility and you've graduated at your previous school, or if you haven't used up your eligibility but you've graduated, you can apply for another year and transfer to another school, which is what, of course, Cody Riggs has done. He's in the MBA program at Notre Dame. So he's been a very big factor with all the injuries they've had in the secondary. He actually was going to play some safety. He's now playing a corner. And he's also a very key player on their punt return team. He's the punt returner. So they've actually improved defensively, and they've improved better on their special team. But, of course, when you think of Notre Dame, you think of Everett Golson, who has had a remarkable year, although the last three games he has put he's turned the ball over 9 times, and that's one thing that concerns Brian Kelly right now. Is Golson was turnoverless his first three games, but right now he's shown let's just say he's not done well protecting the football the last three games.
Well, it seems like Kelly's got them playing really well right now, higher than I expected. They got a little more trouble Saturday than I expected them to, but barring any other unknown injuries, what do you expect out of the Fighting Irish when they play against the number 2 ranked Seminoles at Doak Campbell on Saturday?
Well, again, I think it's going to be a matter of what can the Seminoles do as far as containing Golson. I actually think, athletically, Golson's the best quarterback I've seen at Notre Dame, and I've been watching Notre Dame football for the last 50 years. So, he's got more giddy up, in his step than Tony Rice did. He's a much better thrower than Tony Rice ever was. And I also think, he throws a very good deep ball, and he puts the ball in places where it's not intercepted a lot. The problem he had last week against North Carolina, he turned the ball over twice. North Carolina made it 14-0 lead early in the game, but they were able to come back. Golston is, a very elusive player, and you have to put pressure on him, and you also have to take away the lanes from which he can escape, because if he escapes, he's very quick of foot, and it's tough to bring down. He had 71 yards rushing last week, in addition to passing for 300 yards against North Carolina.
Well, the way schedule looks right now, a good shot for the Fighting Irish to be a factor down the stretch. If they beat the number 2 ranked team on Saturday, They'll be making a bid to become one of those top four teams. Who would have thought it so fast? John Finneran from South Bend, appreciate your time and enjoy the game on Saturday.
Thanks, bud. Nice to talk with you again.
All right, John Finneran. We'll hear from Franz Beard in just a moment. We're going to give him a quick call. And Tom says take a break. We'll try to do that. We'll come back after this timeout.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hey, it's Chrissy with Ocala Mac and PC Repair and Ocala Guest Wi-Fi to let you know we have you covered. We are the only local certified Apple and Microsoft computer company in Ocala. We are family owned and operated. From mobile repair to wireless networks, viruses, new systems, or security cameras, we do it all. Check us out online, ocalamacpc.com, or give us a call, 352-566-8324.
Tell them Nick, Madison, or Mason sent you and get free diagnostic.
Get your internet telephone service from the company that brought affordable internet service to Ocala in the first place. All It Save is a sister company of Ocala Guest Wi-Fi, a company you've known and trusted for all your internet needs. Whether you need a phone or hundreds, we've got the products and services to meet your needs both now and in the future. Our plans include everything from local and long-distance calling to equipment maintenance and even software upgrades. You can count on All It Save to give you cost certainty knowing that your bill will be the same next week, next month, or even next year. Call 352-450-8647 today to learn how to cut your monthly telephone bill up to 60%.
Your home is safe, or is it? AA Lock, Dock, and Security. The name has been a staple in Ocala since 1985. Do you have the right equipment in place to have peace of mind when you are at home or away? AA Lock, Dock, and Security has the right people to install and monitor your home or business. Call today for a free on-site security analysis. Call 867-1965. AA Lock, Dock, and Security, 219 Northwest 10th Street, 867-1965.
Hi, this is JP from Penn Flooring here in Ocala. I would like to invite you to come in and visit our spacious showroom where we have solutions for every style and budget. From wall-to-wall carpet to hardwood floors and tiles, we have an unsurpassed selection of flooring. At Penn Flooring, we've provided quality customer service with a family touch for over 25 years. Visit our website at pennflooring.com or come by our showroom, 1201 Southwest 17th Street, just over the bridge. Penn Flooring, quality customer service with a family touch.
Wrapping up today with Franz Beard, FightingGators.com. And Franz, it was an excruciating loss for Florida. There are lots of plays you could talk about in the final 2 minutes, but I focus on one in particular, third and 25, which was a bit of a shock to the system of everybody, including Will Muschamp. That's a football game and got away. Do you think Jeff Driscoll is going to get all the blame for that loss?
Well, he shouldn't get all the blame, but he certainly should shoulder a good bit of it. I mean, he threw three interceptions in the ball game. He fumbled the ball away. His first interception and the fumble accounted for 14 points. You take those 14 points off the board, Florida wins the ball game. So he's got to shoulder a certain measure of responsibility for the loss.
Two things I want to talk to you about real quick. Just give me a quick answer. First of all, the play on third and 25. Jennings to Jarrell, fantastic, 40-something yards, and they tacked on a 15-yard penalty on top of that. That was a huge play. And then they come back and score on a great one-handed catch by Jarrell. So you got to give them credit. They made the plays when they had to. That being said, they still had a shot to do it. And, of course, the fact is that Jeff Driscoll threw the interception. Ball was tipped. LaTorre Pittman got hurt. And then LSU had the ball and had wise use of their timeouts. In the end, however, the one that really upsets me is the fact I've never really seen a game before where a referee stopped the clock, put time back on the clock in that situation. And I know at least one SEC coach agrees with me. Remember the play? They put seven back on the clock.
Oh, I absolutely remember it. And I haven't seen anything from the SEC office. Yeah, but there is no excuse for that. It is unfathomable that call took place. That being said, Florida should have never been in the position to lose the game.
Yeah, because the dropped pass is what put it. If the pass is not dropped, then Driscoll doesn't have that interception to begin with.
No, if the pass is not, you look at that. I pointed to three critical mistakes that they made, one of them being the third and 25, and
And this is getting all too familiar, buddy, in that, you know, we come here and we have these situations where we say, well, gee, you know, another guy blew a coverage. You know, this is the middle of the season. It's past point in time for guys to be blowing coverages. I'm, you know, it's exasperating.
All right, we got about 10 seconds. Will Muschamp's head's on the chopping block. Will he be spared? And do you think if he beats Missouri that people will begin to say, well, maybe not so bad after all? What do you think the odds are now that Muschamp's the coach at the end of the season?
If he beats Missouri and beats Georgia, he's going to be the coach at the end of the season. He's going to be the coach next year.
Do you think he will?
I don't make predictions with this coach and this team, buddy, but anything is possible.
You're right about that. It's really a crazy scene on the SEC West. All right, Francis, thank you very much. Franz Beard, FightingGators.com. I want to thank our guests today, Azim and Navrat Saju, our Schofield from WarChant.com, John Finneran from South Bend, and Franz Beard from FightingGators.com. On behalf of my broadcast partner, Tom Schmitz, I'm Buddy Martin. Have a great night, everybody.
Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75, exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt golf, and a car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala, proud sponsor of Friday Night High School Football on WOCA, The Source. Imagine yourself in a quaint bistro right in the heart of a charming French village about to indulge in real French cuisine. Located in beautiful, vibrant downtown Ocala, La Cuisine offers authentic French cuisine and wine from an award-winning menu. Patrice and Elodie moved to Ocala in 2009 because they fell in love with it. And you're going to fall in love with La Cuisine if you haven't already. La Cuisine offers a quick bite for lunch or a leisurely dinner in a comfortable and relaxed setting. So call La Cuisine of Ocala today at 352-433-2570. It's like a direct call to Paris. Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75, exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt golf, and a car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala, proud sponsor of Friday Night High School Football on WOCA, The Source.
Are you in the process of planning your wedding reception? Or are you planning that birthday party for someone special? Or maybe you're just looking to throw a party for yourself? Are you in charge of this year's company outing and looking for something fresh and fun to do? Well, KT Entertainment is your answer to all those questions. We provide music, trivia, and karaoke.